Welcome to the fantasy audiobook. Marvel, start merging with Homelander Jean and successfully became the Homelander. Chapter 81. In a secluded suburban village, the X-Men and students of Xavier Academy were currently sitting in front of their televisions, watching the live broadcast of the trial. After witnessing Link's invincible attitude and crushing the military, S.H.I.E.L.D., and the superheroes, they were collectively silent. For Homelander Link, they have mixed feelings. He hates Link, but at the same time admires his invincible power. There were even some students who developed a fanatical attitude towards Link. This group of people are pure power supremacists. Compared to Magneto's mutant supremacism, their ideas are more extreme. However, because of Charles's pressure, they didn't dare to reveal too much and could only keep it in their hearts. But now that Charles is dead, they no longer suppress their thoughts. Some students who are decisive and active have already sneaked away and are preparing to join Link. All this must be concluded as soon as possible. Logan, Quicksilver and others naturally noticed this change. As the saying goes, if people's hearts are scattered, it will be difficult to lead the team. So, they were a little anxious. Thinking of this, Logan couldn't wait to lie on the stone platform. With the help of Lucas's amplification, Phantom Cat started to reverse the future again. With Lucas's help this time, I can last 10 minutes. 10 minutes should be enough for Logan to change. If the future is reversed successfully this time, the new timeline will overwrite the past timeline, thus forcibly changing the old history. In this way, the dead Charles and the X-Men can be resurrected. And Homelander Link may no longer exist. The other side. Logan walked across, breathing heavily. The aftereffects of this time travel were more severe than the last time, and it almost caused his consciousness to collapse during the journey. But fortunately, he got through it with his strong willpower. He knew very well that time was running out, that the speed of time flowing in the two worlds was different, and that he needed to reduce the burden on Phantom Cat as much as possible, so he had to act as quickly as possible. He hijacked a motorcycle and sped madly towards the orphanage. With the experience from last time, he quickly arrived at his destination and took immediate action. As night fell, Logan sneaked into the orphanage like a wolf lurking in the darkness, carrying a cold murderous intent. Logan moved quickly, swiftly crossing the corridor and heading straight for the room where Link was. Arriving in front of Link's room, the adamantium claws flashed with cold light, easily tore open the door, and rushed in quickly. He has to be quick. Because he didn't dare to bet whether flashing had awakened his superpowers now. So, he had to kill Link in one fell swoop before Flash could react. He held his breath, his eyes ferocious, and approached his prey silently like a hungry beast. At the same time, Link in the room has also woken up. As his future memories came back to him, his gaze became more and more sinister. It turns out to be reversing the future. 2.5 minutes ago, Link's memory was still in the future. However, a sense of crisis suddenly arose, causing him to fall into deep thought. This is not the first time this situation has occurred. Link quickly realized that this crisis most likely did not come from the present, but from the future or the past. In other words, someone secretly traveled through time to kill him in the future or past. Going to the future to kill him, Link immediately denied this possibility. After all, no one can kill him now, and there will be no such person in the future. So excluding the future, there is only one truth, the past timeline. Thinking of this, Link suddenly remembered the plot of X-Men Days of Future Past. Phantom has developed a new ability that allows him to send Wolverine's consciousness from the present timeline back into Wolverine's body from the past timeline. No wonder, it turns out the X-Men wanted to go back in time and kill me. Link narrowed his eyes and said, "So the strange man who appeared inexplicably in my memory is most likely Wolverine. Ding, you have evolved a superpower, time and space displacement." At this moment, the long-lost evolutionary mechanism was triggered, and the time and space displacement started autonomously. Link's consciousness was drawn into the long river of time and space, swimming like a fish to a certain time point in the past. After waking up, Link found himself back in the orphanage, and the time was currently 12 o'clock in the evening. Only telekinesis was brought here. Link frowned, most of his future superpowers gone. However, superpowers related to the spiritual level, such as telekinesis, super intuition, super thinking, etc., are still there. Enough. Link clenched his fists, his eyes full of confidence. Ah, weirdos. Suddenly, a scream broke the silence of the night. It was the sound of flickering. She wanted to go to the bathroom, but unexpectedly saw Logan in the dim corridor. She screamed immediately in shock. Logan ignored the screaming flicker and rushed straight into Link's bedroom. He knew that this scream would definitely wake up Link inside. Therefore, he had to kill the opponent before Link could react. But the moment Logan rushed into the room, he was pinned down by an invisible force. Then, he seemed to be grabbed by an invisible hand and his body was suspended in midair. It's you, Wolverine. Link sat upright on the bed, looking at Logan with a cold expression. This time, the other party was not wearing a hood. So, Link recognized it at a glance. You really went to great lengths to kill me. A strong murderous intent flashed in Link's eyes. If he didn't have infinite evolution, he would probably have been killed by the X-Men today. This superpower that can reverse the future is simply a bug. Even if it doesn't work this time, what about next time? And the next time. There will always be a success in the end. And once he lets the other party succeed, there is no need to think too much, he will be finished. The more Link thought about it, the angrier he got. In his rage, he used his telekinesis at full power and instantly twisted Logan's body into a knot. Ah, Logan screamed in pain, and just as his consciousness collapsed, he yelled, "Katie, reset the timeline quickly." As soon as he finished speaking, Logan's figure began to blur, and finally disappeared out of thin air like a ghost. It turns out that in the future timeline, Logan's body suddenly twisted and deformed. Phantom Cat immediately noticed the change and quickly disconnected the time travel, reset the timeline, and forced Logan to return to an earlier timeline node. Fake. Link's face darkened. He was just a little bit away from killing Wolverine. Time and space displacement can only be applied to a certain time point and cannot allow him to stay in the past for a long time. Therefore, after the crisis was resolved, the time and space displacement also lost its effect. The next second, his consciousness was drawn into the river of time again and returned to his body in the future. X-Men, Days of Future Past. After returning to reality, Link's face looked extremely ugly, and he was filled with murderous intent. The ability to travel through timelines to kill targets is so incredible that it is enough to threaten him. So, he must kill Phantom Cat. Thinking of this, Link immediately activated the time and space replacement at maximum power. By consuming 1,000 million energy plus 10 superpowers, you can unlock another function of time and space replacement, cause and effect tracing. Anyone who has a causal relationship with Link can be accurately traced back to that person's location along the causal line. To put it simply, causal tracing is similar to satellite positioning. No matter where a person is, even if they are not on Earth, Link can find them by following the line of cause and effect. The moment Link activated the cause and effect tracing, the originally clear sky suddenly became dim and an invisible force swept across the world. At the same time, Logan, who was thousands of miles away, suddenly felt that he was locked by an invisible force. Found you, Wolverine. Somehow, Link's voice appeared in Logan's mind. Homelander, what the hell is going on? Hearing this voice, Logan's expression changed instantly. Then, he discovered to his horror that the surrounding environment suddenly changed. Moreover, Link appeared in front of him. Don't be surprised, this is the time point when we will meet in the future. At this moment, Link looked at Logan as if he was looking at a dead person. He consumed tens of millions of energies and 10 kinds of superpowers, so it would naturally not be as simple as just starting up the cause and effect tracing. After tracing back the cause and effect, the next step is the replacement of time and space. Simply put, after tracing back to the target, the time and space displacement will forcibly bring the target's consciousness to a certain time point in the future. And this time node can be set by Link. Just like the scene before him, Link set it as the time node for the two to meet in the future. And this time point may be one day later, or perhaps a year later. But no matter what the time point is, as long as the target is marked by causal tracing, meeting in the future has become an inevitable result. You can't hide. How can it be? Logan looked incredulous. Okay, just go on your way with peace of mind. Because the time and space replacement cannot be maintained for too long, Link was too lazy to talk nonsense with the other party. He directly used telekinesis to twist Logan's body into a knot again, and then used a solar storm to burn it to ashes. The whole process was over in less than 10 seconds. The perspective returns to the present timeline. Under the astonished gaze of Quicksilver, Phantom Cat, Lucas and others, Logan turned into a pile of ashes out of thin air. What's even more bizarre is that all this happened without any warning. Don't they know how Logan turned into ashes? A few more seconds passed. Suddenly, Phantom and Lucas followed in Logan's footsteps and turned into a pile of ashes out of thin air. Seeing three living people turning into ashes right in front of their eyes, Iceman, Quicksilver and others showed horror on their faces. In the end, what happened? Why did Logan and Phantom Cat, they turned into gray for no apparent reason? Can anyone tell me what happened? A chill went up everyone's spine, and they all felt an unprecedented fear. As the saying goes, the unknown is the most frightening thing. Faced with such a strange and terrifying situation, Quicksilver and others were not only sad and angry, but also more terrified. The scene instantly fell into chaos. Iceman looked at Quicksilver anxiously, his eyes full of fear and confusion. This is so scary. Three living people turned into ashes out of thin air, and they couldn't figure out the reason. There must be some kind of power at work. Suddenly, a person flashed through Quicksilver's mind. My motherland, it must be my motherland. Yes, he must be the one behind this. This is the only reasonable explanation at the moment. Although, they couldn't figure out how Link did it. But their intuition told them that this matter must be related to Link. At the same time, Ministry of National Defense, inside the quadrangle. Stryker, who was hiding in a closed secret room, was watching TV with a gloomy face. When he saw Link killing people and wiping out the cyborg army, his heart was filled with fear. He finally realized that he had provoked a monster that should not have been provoked. Fake. Stryker's face was grim. As long as Link is alive, he will have to hide in the dark forever and never see the light of day. Otherwise, the fate of those transformed people will be his future fate. At this moment, Link's voice suddenly sounded in Stryker's mind. So you were hiding here in the quadrangle. Hearing this familiar voice, Stryker, like Logan, first showed shock on his face, followed by fear. People of the motherland, Stryker was so frightened that he jumped up instantly and looked around in panic. Haha, don't be afraid, because you will be able to sleep peacefully soon. As soon as Link finished his words, the quadrangle was hit by a charging beam and the entire building was instantly reduced to ashes. Back to the present timeline. Under the shocked witness of countless people, the quadrangle disappeared out of thin air, leaving only a super large deep pit in its place. The other side, Link returned to the present timeline. He stood quietly at the edge of the pit, still in a contemplative posture. What just happened seemed complicated, but in reality, less than 2.5 minutes had passed. Phantom Cat, the biggest threat has been dealt with. And that Stryker, along with the quadrangle, was also nuked by me in the future. Well, this wave of energy and superpowers is worth it. Link nodded with satisfaction. Admittedly, the cost of initiating time-space displacement and causal tracing is quite high. But the effects of these two superpowers are worth the price. Of course, at this stage, the cost-effectiveness of these two superpowers is still not high. If he had known that Stryker was hiding in the quadrangle, he wouldn't have had to go to the future timeline to kill him. He could have killed him in the present timeline. By the way, I killed Wolverine and the others, why is there no energy dropped? This question suddenly occurred to Link. Ding! The energy currently stays at a certain node in the future timeline. The host can only absorb this energy when that time node is reached. I see, Link suddenly realized. At this moment, cheers came from not far away. People of the motherland, King of Mutants. After defeating the shield agents, the mutants immediately gathered at the edge of the giant pit, waving their arms and shouting, expressing their highest respect to Link. As a vulnerable group that has always been oppressed, they have suffered discrimination and torture for many years. Some even face the tragic fate of being dissected and studied. Now, they have finally waited for a leader, a powerful leader who can fight for their dignity and survival. Therefore, their cheers were sincere and enthusiastic. Everyone looked at Link with admiration, as if they were looking at a god. A god on Earth. Mutants have long been marginalized by human society. They were seen as aliens and were ostracized by the public out of fear. In addition, the weakness and compromise of the X-Men and the extremism of the Brotherhood of Mutants pushed their group into the abyss, making their survival situation increasingly difficult. But now, their hope has emerged. That's the motherland. So at this moment, the mutants were excited and cheered loudly. Hope for the future is burning in everyone's heart. Caliban, the albino mutant who appeared in Logan, stood up again at this time. He spoke forcefully and appealed in an inspiring voice. Gentlemen, for the sake of our future, please join me in serving our motherland. Yes, serve our motherland. Juggernaut, the mutant who once worked for Magneto, has now joined the call, and his roar is heart-shaking. What surprised Link even more was that Twinkle actually came to the scene with Daisy. At this moment, her eyes were full of love and admiration for Link, like a little fangirl, and she also joined in this huge appeal. Link took a deep breath, realizing that at this moment, he could no longer escape. He slowly rose into the air, with his arms spread out as if embracing the whole world. Link shouted loudly, his voice resounding through the sky, "I accept your allegiance. From today on, you are a member of the Black Robe Patrol. And I, your leader, now officially give you my first order. Kill Shield." Link's voice was loud and firm, like lightning breaking through the sky. As soon as these words were spoken, all the mutants in the audience cheered and shouted one after another, surging like waves. A brand new era is coming. And Link is the leader of this era. Shield, Triskelion Building. At this moment, this place is like an isolated island, crumbling in the storm. After Link and the mutant group's liquidation, there are less than 25% of SHIELD agents left. Although Nick Fury was panicking inside, he pretended to be calm on the surface. He detected through satellites that mutants were pouring in like a tide, and knew that the game was over. He decisively abandoned his headquarters, planning to lie low and wait for an opportunity to make a comeback. However, before leaving, Nick Fury received another piece of news that shocked and angered him. The aerospace carrier has lost contact. Nick Fury frowned, feeling uneasy. What he didn't know was that the Hydra personnel within SHIELD had already launched a rebellion. Not only the aerospace mothership, but also many high-tech weapons have been stolen by Hydra. The entire SHIELD is now in chaos. But Nick Fury knew that this was just the beginning of the storm. SHIELD possesses many amazing black technologies. Among them, the most distinctive are the B-2 Phantom Fighter and the Aerospace Carrier. Especially the Aerospace Carrier, which is simply the overlord of the sky and the proud work of SHIELD. But now, this helicarrier has been stolen by Hydra. As the alarm sounded, the black-robed patrol team poured into the Triskelion Building like a tide. However, just as they were pouring in, an island-like building slowly rises from the surface of the isolated lake. It turns out to be a hidden underwater base. Oh no, the helicarrier is about to escape. Stop him now. The mutants' faces changed and they accelerated their invasion, wanting to board the deck before the mothership set sail and break into the interior of the mothership in one fell swoop. The other side, following the order from Alexander Pierce, the commander of Hydra and the right-hand man of the director of SHIELD, the four engines of the aerospace carrier ran at full capacity, pushing the island-like mothership straight into the sky. However, at this critical moment, a terrifying telekinesis came and instantly enveloped the entire aerospace mothership. Link was suspended in midair, a cold light flashing in his eyes. "You want to escape right under my nose? Are you just dreaming?" He released an astonishing telekinetic field, suppressing the huge aerospace mothership directly in place, making it unable to move. How can it be? At this time, screams of fear were heard one after another inside the aerospace mothership. Pierce never expected that Homelander's power would be so perverted. They had never experienced it themselves before, so it was inevitable that they had some misunderstandings about Link's power. But now, after experiencing it themselves, they finally understood why those superheroes were defeated so miserably. This is not a power that ordinary mutants can possess. Even Magneto would find it difficult to achieve this. "Guys, take the mothership for me." Following Link's order, countless mutants swarmed in and finally stepped onto the deck of the helicarrier. Red Tank, the tanky mutant, took the lead as the pioneer. Following closely behind are mutants who are good at flying or space travel. They swarmed into the mothership like locusts. "Boss." Caliban came to Link's side and reported respectfully, "We have a mutant named Bradley among us. he has the ability to control the sky and space carriers for our use. In the movie, Bradley was killed by a saber-toothed tiger. Here, Bradley did not die. Wen Shanting, who was present, heard this, his eyes sparkled with excitement. That's great, this aerospace carrier will be our mount from now on. Don't think that only boys like big guys. Sometimes, girls like this kind of big thing more than boys. The other side, although it was suppressed by telekinesis, the helical carrier did not surrender easily. Hundreds of laser cannons protruded from its hull, with their muzzles pointed at the Triskelion building. It was clear that Pierce wanted to create chaos by destroying the building. The purpose of his doing this was, of course, to distract Link's attention. This way, the aerospace carrier would have a chance to escape. But Link remained unmoved. He stretched out his right hand and clenched it into a fist. After a buzzing sound, the laser from the barrel could not be fired, completely blocked by invisible telekinesis. Want to come? Don't even think about it without my permission. Link snorted, then landed on the deck of the mothership with Twinkle and Daisy. Standing here, he marveled at the advancement and size of the mothership. The phantom fighters on both sides of the deck made this pseudo-military fan's eyes light up. Let's go in and take a look inside, Link said softly, before leading the two women deeper into the interior of the mothership. He already had a plan in mind. He was going to transform this aerospace mothership into the headquarters of the Black Rogue Patrol. Just thinking about it made him feel impressive. As for Twinkle and Daisy, they were also attracted by the scene inside the mothership and completely forgot that there were Hydra people inside. In other words, they didn't take Hydra seriously at all and simply ignored them. Mutants, we are Hydra. How dare you provoke us? Aren't you afraid of Hydra's revenge? Amid the deafening roars, a group of Hydra agents in suits and leather shoes are struggling to resist the invading mutants. However, the red tank simply ignored their words and, like a human tank, instantly killed the two Hydra agents. Long live Hydra! Before they died, the two Hydra agents looked crazy and detonated the bombs on their bodies in an attempt to kill the mutants nearby. Seeing this, Link waved his hand lightly and used telekinesis to instantly eliminate the bomb. The two Hydra agents were dumbfounded, and then fell to the ground and died in despair and unwillingness. At this time, Link floated outside the command room, and wherever his eyes passed, he telepathically read the memories of all Hydra agents. My memory has been read. Some Hydra agents reacted and were immediately terrified. In order to prevent the leakage of secrets, they chose to commit suicide by pointing the gun at their own heads and pulling the trigger. Homelander, Hydra will not let you go. Once we welcome our master back, it will be your end. The Hydra agent's determination shocked all the mutants present. However, Red Tank was disdainful of this. Hydra, what a piece of shit, don't let me meet it, or I'll beat you up every time I see you. Well said, Link patted Red Tank's shoulder with satisfaction. After receiving Link's personal commendation, Red Tank puffed out his chest with pride, feeling honored. Hydra is nothing more than a group of rats hiding in the dark. Link looked at everyone and said casually, if you encounter Hydra people in the future, just beat them to death. Yes, the mutants responded one after another. Very good, very energetic. Link waved his hand and said, next, take care of this building and the aerospace mothership as quickly as possible. Follow orders. After receiving the new instructions, the mutants immediately burst out with great fighting spirit and action. In just 2.5 hours, the Triskelion building, which symbolizes the headquarters of SHIELD, was completely under Link's control. Unfortunately, a large amount of information has been deleted by Nick Fury, who fled. This also includes top-secret documents. Even Daisy, who possesses top-notch hacking skills, cannot fully restore it. Nick Fury, the man who was once praised as knowing the most secrets on Earth, created a top-secret file database. How many secrets are recorded in it? It is estimated that only he himself knows how many secrets are recorded in it. Soon after, the Hydra agents inside the helicarrier were also cleared out. At this point, the Triskelion building and the aerospace mothership also became Link's trophies. After occupying the helicarrier, more than a dozen ghost fighters immediately flew out from the deck, piloted by mutant pilots, and headed straight for the city of Manhattan. Because just now, they received new instructions from Link to take over the Stark building and the Baxter building in Manhattan. These two high-tech buildings, which integrate countless scientific research technologies, will become branches of the Black Robe Patrol team. Just then, Bradley brought an unexpected surprise. "Chief, I have just successfully restored some top-secret information. There is a piece of information among them that I think you will be interested in." Link was a little surprised. "Oh, what information?" "SHIELD built an experimental base in British Columbia called Operation Pegasus, or Operation Dark Energy," Bradley added. "The experimental base stores a magical thing called the Cosmic Cube. It is with the help of the Cosmic Cube that SHIELD has developed many high-tech weapons." Upon hearing this top-secret information, everyone present was surprised. Link, in particular, his eyes lit up instantly. "He is no stranger to the Cosmic Cube. That is the container of the space gem. More importantly, gems contain almost endless energy. If you absorb it." Thinking of this, Link immediately lost his composure. He gave Caliban the order to command the scene, and then he personally led a team of people on the journey to the Dark Energy Operations Base. At the same time, Baxter Building, top 5th floor. "This place has been transformed into an experimental base full of technology. On the rooftop, there is a magical flying car parked. This is the vehicle Reed uses to explore negative space. On one side of the building, a rocket launch pad towers into the clouds, capable of launching rockets into space at any time. In addition, Reed also set up a door leading to the negative space. The main function is to study the theory of parallel universes. However, just recently, this door to the negative space was actually closed by a little boy. Franklin Richards, the son of Mr. Fantastic and the Invisible Woman, is a mutant with the potential to surpass the Omega level." At this moment, he was standing on the rooftop, his eyes burning with flames. Just now, he followed Nick Fury's advice and left home with his sister Valeria. Valeria is also a mutant, and her IQ is recognized to surpass Reed, and her future achievements will definitely be higher than Reed. However, these two children were so rebellious that they could only watch their parents die at the hands of their fellow countrymen and were powerless to do anything. At this moment, they stood on the rooftop, looking into the distance, the fire of revenge burning in their eyes. Franklin secretly swore, "My countrymen, I will definitely seek revenge on you." Nick Fury, who had escaped by chance, came here in person to pick them up. "There is no other way. If Nick Fury wants to defeat the nearly invincible Homelander, he can only rely on Franklin. In order to avoid Link's sphere of influence, Nick Fury plans to take them to the West Coast. There, he will form a new West Coast Avengers." The night sky was as deep as ink, and the Ghost Fighter jets streaked across the sky like meteors, flying rapidly towards the Dark Energy Operations Base. Boom! At this moment, the night was torn apart by sudden lightning. Endless dark clouds gathered quickly, thunder and lightning danced wildly in the clouds, and directly hit the group of fighter planes. Seeing this scene, the driver's horror was beyond words. In such dense lightning strikes, the fighter planes had nowhere to hide and could only watch helplessly as the lightning struck them. But to the astonishment of all the pilots, these devastating lightning did not cause any substantial damage to the fighter planes. They understood instantly that it was the leader who took action. "You guys go back first," Link's voice echoed in every driver's mind. Then, he used telekinesis to build a protective shield for all combat structures. With the protection of the shield, lightning and thunder can't do anything to the fighter plane. After receiving the order, the fighter planes left one after another and returned to Manhattan. In midair, Link was the only one left looking up at the sky. Could it be him? Link thought of a muscular brother in his mind, and then he rushed into the sea of thunder impatiently. He wants to meet this muscular brother. Thunderbolt. Endless lightning continued to strike, trying to kill Link, who was rushing towards him. But unfortunately, the lightning struck Link and only emitted a wisp of green smoke before dissipating. Not to mention killing Link, even Link's clothes weren't damaged. "That's all electrotherapy is, not as good as Yang Yangxin," Link taunted mercilessly. "Boy, you dare to mock me, the God of Thunder." Suddenly, a loud roar exploded in the sky. Then, in the dark clouded sky, a figure wrapped in the power of thunder and holding a huge hammer broke through the clouds. It was the famous Thor, the God of Thunder. He swung Thor's hammer and smashed it at Link with the force of thunder. Amid a deafening roar, Thor's hammer had not yet touched Link, but the electric snakes had already bitten him first. Link was surprised. The power contained in the lightning was extraordinary, as if it possessed some kind of divinity. However, he showed no fear or retreat. Link sneered, facing the giant hammer, swinging his fist and attacking it directly. Thor was slightly stunned. It was the first time he encountered an opponent who dared to go head-on with Thor's hammer. He wondered in his heart, doesn't this human know about Thor's hammer? You ignorant person, you will regret it later. Thor sneered in his heart and swung the hammer even harder. Boom, there was a loud bang. Link was knocked away by the impact of Thor's hammer, and his body instantly disappeared thousands of meters away, and only stopped after crashing into a mountain. Didn't the evolution mechanism get triggered? Link frowned, looking somewhat helpless. Man of Steel plus Tyrant Body plus Black Hole Stomach plus Speed Force Vibration plus Super Flexible Cells. With so many superpowers, his body is too strong and it is difficult to get hurt under normal circumstances. Sometimes, Link also thought about taking a walk in the sun. Well, this is a good idea. I should go and try it out when I have time. Putting aside all distractions, Link's eyes burned with fighting spirit. He transformed into a beam of lightning and instantly crossed thousands of meters, returning to Thor's sight. Everything is fine. Thor's face changed when he saw this. He never expected that after being hit head-on by his hammer, the opponent would remain unharmed. You know, that's 80% of his strength. It is no exaggeration to say that a skyscraper would be destroyed by one blow of the hammer. But the other party is actually fine. Don't be surprised. There is only one truth, and that is, you are too weak. As soon as Link finished his words, he teleported in front of Thor and delivered an unstoppable punch. Bang! Thor had no time to react before he was knocked thousands of meters away. This speed, as he flew backwards, Thor's face was full of disbelief. He quickly steadied himself and looked down at his chest, only to find that his armor had been dented and was almost pierced by the opponent. This power, while Thor was shocked, he finally realized how terrifying Link was. Could it be that the person my father asked me to investigate in the lower world is him? Thinking of this, Thor dared not be careless anymore. He immediately opened fire at full power, and Thor's hammer drew endless lightning to bombard Link. Rumble! Under the dark clouds, thunder poured down like a waterfall, bombarding Link madly. The power of each lightning bolt is enough to shatter mountains. But when it hit Link, it had no effect at all. Impossible! Thor opened his eyes wide and looked like he had seen a ghost. Nothing is impossible. As I said before, you are too weak. Ignoring the baptism of thunder, Link passed through layers of lightning and hit Thor with his fist again. This time, he was directly knocked thousands of meters away and did not stop until he broke a section of the mountain. God, that's it. Link followed like a shadow and arrived 10,000 meters away one step earlier than Thor. Before Thor could react, Link's fist hit him in the abdomen again. Puff! Thor spat out a mouthful of blood, his body bent like a shrimp, and intense pain spread throughout his body. Compared to physical pain, the mental blow and humiliation made Thor even more angry. Ah! He roared to the sky, swung Thor's hammer back, and smashed it hard at Link. Link snorted coldly, and swung his fist without showing any weakness, hitting Thor's hammer. Boom! The terrifying roar turned into a shock wave and spread. Thor felt a tremendous force coming at him, and the hammer he was holding tightly was almost dropped from his hands. At the same time, he was knocked back hundreds of meters by the impact force. Through these head-on confrontations, he finally realized that Link's strength was far superior to his own. However, he couldn't understand it. How could an Earthling possess such incredible power? Even stronger than him, the God of Thunder. What? This won't work. Link was suspended in midair, looking down at Thor below. That tone, that gesture, that look. Naked contempt. Arrogant. Thor was instantly enraged. As the son of the god King Odin and the strongest warrior of the Aesir, he could not accept being defeated by a human. For honor, for dignity. I can't lose. Thor was in high spirits. He raised his hammer high, drew endless lightning to himself, and launched a fierce attack on Link again. Boom, boom, boom. The roar was deafening. The two of them transformed into two streams of light, one blue and one red, which kept colliding violently in the sky. With every collision, A circle of terrifying energy waves erupted in the sky, instantly tearing apart the dark clouds and the night sky. In just 2.5 minutes, the two collided tens of thousands of times. Although they seemed evenly matched, Thor actually had no way of saying anything. Because with every collision, his knuckles would crack. There's no way, Link's power is too abnormal. Every punch is as powerful as a nuclear explosion. In other words, his divine body was strong enough that he could barely hold on. If it were someone else, they would have been shocked to death by the opponent's strength. Not bad, it seems your body is still quite strong. Link's tone was full of teasing. Thor was furious when he heard this. Link's attitude deeply hurt his proud heart. His defense was broken, and he vowed in his heart to defeat Link and wash away this humiliation. However, the following confrontation. Not only did he fail to wash away the humiliation, but he was beaten to a pulp by Link. Link punched out, and a terrifying force exploded. Thor smashed his body and hammer towards the mountain below, directly smashing half of a mountain hundreds of meters high. PFF, Thor was spitting out mouthfuls of blood, and his right arm holding the hammer was broken. What made him even more upset was that there was a crack on Thor's hammer. This, Thor looked incredulous. This Thor's hammer is made of indestructible Uru metal, and it is attached with a lot of magic and is even blessed by Odin's spell. Such a super artifact was actually broken by someone's fist. Thor roared angrily, and Thor's hammer spun wildly in his hands, stirring up violent thunder that seemed to tear the void apart. At this moment, he drew lightning into his body, wearing thunder armor, like a god of war, and rushed straight towards Link. Another explosion. Link's face was calm, but his fighting spirit was burning like a prairie fire. A tremendous force surged through his limbs and bones, and he raised his fist to meet the blow head-on. Boom! The two collided again, and a terrifying energy tide burst out in the night sky. A big hole was suddenly torn in the sky, shocking everyone. This energy tide spread far and wide, and all the mountains over 500 meters were flattened by the tide. Immediately afterwards, a figure fell like a meteor and smashed heavily into a mountain below. The mountain collapsed under the impact, with rubble flying and smoke and dust billowing. Thor's figure appeared in the smoke and dust. At this time, he was vomiting blood, his armor was torn, his body was covered in blood, and he looked extremely miserable. "Impossible," he roared in pain, his voice filled with despair. Because Thor's hammer was broken into pieces, leaving only the handle. This super artifact was actually blown up by Link. Thor was angry and unwilling. He could not accept failure, and even more so, he could not accept his beloved artifact being exploded. At this moment, his pride and self-esteem were completely shattered. He struggled to get up, but his bruised body prevented him from moving. He had never been injured so badly before, but he was unwilling to fall down. "Come again," he roared, venting his anger and unwillingness to Link, who was towering above him. Even though he was seriously injured and even though the artifact was destroyed, he would fight Link to the end. Link was suspended in the air, his arms crossed over his chest, looking down at Thor with a cold expression. There was contempt and disdain in his eyes, as if he was mocking Thor's incompetence. Thor, the strongest warrior of the Aesir, was now as angry and helpless as a trapped beast. He couldn't accept being looked down upon by a human being like this. This feeling was like a sharp knife stabbing his heart, making him feel like dying. "I haven't lost yet," Thor roared, struggled to get up, and fought Link for another 800 rounds. However, his severely injured body made it impossible for him to do so. Hum, suddenly, a bright rainbow beam of light appeared in the night sky, carrying tremendous divine power, instantly enveloping Thor. It turned out to be the teleportation artifact of the Asgard realm, the Rainbow Bridge. Link didn't pay attention to Thor, who was about to escape, but instead focused on the Rainbow Bridge. He looked up into the sky and saw a rainbow beam of light expanding rapidly, completely submerging Thor's figure. "No, I can't just leave like this," Thor roared in the column of light, unwilling to be a deserter. However, the power of the Rainbow Bridge was irresistible, and it disappeared into the night sky with Thor's figure. Link did not stop him, but deliberately let Thor go. After all, the current Thor is a bit too weak for him. Therefore, Link planned to fatten himself up first, which should allow him to absorb more energy. As for whether it will overturn, oh, If he can't even do this, it means he's not strong enough. Moreover, Link also longs to flip over himself, so that he can evolve more powerfully. Asgard's domain. Link's eyes flashed with anticipation. If Asgard were wiped out in one fell swoop, all the gods would be sucked dry. Then shouldn't he take off from the spot? Also, Odin, who is a father figure, is stronger than Thor and may be able to promote his own evolution. Thinking about it this way, Link felt more and more that deliberately letting Thor go was a wise decision. After all, you have to bait the bait before fishing. He wished Thor would go back and ask for more powerful gods to come to him, so that he wouldn't have to look for them one by one. At the same time, a ray of colorful light surged from the direction of the earth and merged into the rainbow bridge of the Asgard Divine Realm. Heimdall quickly stepped forward and caught the collapsed Thor. At this time, Thor was covered in blood, seriously injured and dying, and his condition was very bad. Quick, call a doctor. Heimdall quickly injected divine power to help Thor stabilize his injuries. I lost completely, Thor muttered to himself, his eyes full of disappointment. Link's strength made him feel ashamed. Simply put, he, like the Hulk, became autistic after being beaten by Link. Moreover, he understood that the reason he was able to come back was not because Link was unable to stop him, but because the other party deliberately let him go. For the proud man like him, this was even more painful than killing him. After this blow, Thor's will was extremely depressed. He began to give up on himself and resisted Heimdall's divine healing. Heimdall, the usually calm guardian god, was also angry at this time. The once high-spirited Thor has now become so decadent and listless that he even refuses to receive treatment and is determined to die. This is simply a cowardly behavior. Thor, cheer up! Heimdall roared. Thor's hammer is only your symbol, not the source of your power. You are the son of Odin, the future lord of Asgard. Remember, your power is beyond your imagination. However, Thor had fallen into despair at this time and turned a deaf ear to Heimdall's advice, like a body without a soul. Heimdall's heart sank to the bottom. He had eyes that could see through the nine realms. So, I just witnessed with my own eyes that Link crushed Thor with his absolute strength. Of course he knew that Thor's faith was broken by Link's attack. At this moment, Asgard's medical staff quickly arrived. They possess medical magic that surpasses Earth's medical technology. But now Thor is depressed and even resists treatment. This left them completely helpless. The old Odin fell into a deep sleep due to his injuries and was temporarily unable to leave Valhalla. Therefore, Asgard can only rely on Thor, the top combat force at present. However, Thor was defeated so thoroughly that even the symbol of his status, the hammer of Thor, was blown up by the enemy. Heimdall also felt powerless about this. Perhaps, we can only rely on Odin. Heimdall sighed secretly. The other side, somewhere in the Rocky Mountains, a dozen Asgard warriors wandered anxiously. They couldn't see the battle 10,000 meters away, but they saw the Rainbow Bridge falling from the sky. The arrival of the Rainbow Bridge means there is only one possibility, that is, Thor, the God of Thunder, is being taken back to the realm of God. In other words, Thor was defeated. This news terrified them. The invincible Thor was defeated. Don't be discouraged. Maybe it's not what we think. Although some people tried to boost morale, the powerlessness in their voices was hard to conceal. Because even he himself probably doesn't believe such self-deceiving words. You guys are quite Aku-like. At this moment, a teasing voice suddenly came from the sky. Then, Link appeared out of nowhere, standing in the air, overlooking the warriors. The Asgardian warriors looked up, their eyes filled with fear. It's over now, barbecue is gone. Ding. Energy X14 detected, do you want to absorb it? Absorb. Ding. The energy has been absorbed and converted into genetic energy by 420 million calories. The energy limit has exceeded 2,930 million calories. Ding. Due to the influence of 14 energies, you have evolved superpowers, super body density. Ding. Due to the super body density, super flexible cells, and the same origin as Man of Steel 2, it has been autonomously fused into superpowers, Man of Steel 3. Just as Link killed the last Asgardian warrior. The other side. Under the night sky, a group of ghost fighters used advanced stealth technology to successfully avoid radar detection and invaded the sky above the Dark Energy Operation Base. These fighters do not rely on simple stealth codings, but truly disappear from human sight. After the fighter planes successfully invaded, mutants jumped off the planes one by one and began to occupy the base. Among them, the red tank is particularly eye-catching. Boom! He fell from a high altitude like a meteorite, slamming into the building, instantly destroying the dome of the base and killing several base soldiers in one fell swoop. This tank, who is comparable to the Hulk, remains safe and sound even after falling from a high altitude. He stood up easily from the ruins and continued to sprint into the base. The moment the mutants invaded, Maria Hill, the person in charge of the base, was already preparing for an emergency evacuation. However, because the dismantling and moving process of the cosmic cube was extremely difficult, Hill couldn't go faster even if he wanted to. Faced with this urgent situation, Hill immediately had the idea of destroying the cosmic cube rather than giving it to the invaders. But just as Hill was about to take action to destroy the cosmic cube, Bradley got there before her and took control of the entire base's network system. The base system is out of control. Hill's pretty face changed, and she immediately realized that the situation was hopeless. There was no other way, she could only evacuate from the secret passage unwillingly. Boom! At the same time, the red tank broke through the wall with amazing force and rushed into the command room. However, when he rushed in, he found that everyone inside had left. "You're one step too slow again," Red Tank cursed loudly. The same thing happened during the previous invasion of the Triskelion building. He originally wanted to catch Nick Fury first, but unexpectedly, Nick Fury escaped in the end. The other side, in the base warehouse, the mutants were surprised to find a large number of high-tech weapons. "Wong Defa, we got rich this time. Are these the latest models of energy weapons?" Looking at the rows of guns on the shelves, their eyes sparkled with excitement. "These energy guns are silver all over, fitting together seamlessly as if they were one, and are full of a futuristic sense of technology." A mutant excitedly picked up one of the guns, pressed the button, and a ball of brilliant light bullet immediately sprayed out from the muzzle. Boom! With a deafening roar, a hole was instantly opened in the alloy wall in front. Hiss! This power is comparable to a missile. The power of energy guns is shocking. All the mutants present had never expected that this secret base of SHIELD actually hid such terrifying high-tech weapons. If SHIELD uses these weapons against them, hiss, it's creepy just thinking about it. And all these terrifying black tech weapons originated from that cosmic cube. The cosmic cube contains endless cosmic energy, which can provide an endless supply of ammunition for energy guns. In the past, Tony's father Howard even developed the prototype of a new element from the cosmic cube. Although it was impossible to fully refine it with the technology at that time, it was still enough to shock the world. "With the cosmic cube, our weapon's shortcomings will be solved. This will become the biggest killer weapon for our Black Robe Patrol team to dominate the world. The mutants are full of confidence and look forward to the future. The leader is here. Everyone, come and greet him." Just then, an excited shout was heard from outside. Upon hearing this, the mutants came to the outside of the base to welcome the arrival of their king. The next day, Link woke up from his couch in the base. Last night, after occupying the base, he spent the night here. As the dust settles, the global landscape is undergoing tremendous changes. At Link's call, a large number of mutants gathered in Manhattan from all over the world. With Manhattan as its center, the boys have established branches in every district, and their sphere of influence is spreading to all states at a very fast speed. However, with the rapid expansion of power, new challenges also arise. Top combat capability, weapons resources and elite backbones are already available. However, the financial resources to maintain the existing order has become a problem to be solved. To maintain such a huge force, Jin Bing's wealth alone is not enough. To this end, Link has sent Caliban and Erica to sweep up the major forces in Manhattan and try to integrate as many resources as possible. Although dealing with these complicated matters was mentally taxing, Link also enjoyed it. Because as his vision broadened, a strong ambition arose in his heart. 9 divine realms, infinite dimensions, parallel worlds, multiverses. They all contain endless opportunities, and they are all waiting for you to discover and explore. And the Earth is just the starting point. My journey is to the Sea of Stars. Link whispered, his voice full of determination and confidence. This is his goal and the direction of his future struggle. So before that, he must first dominate the Earth and integrate more resources to achieve his goals. Link, wake up, come and have breakfast. At this time, Twinkle and Daisy came in with bright smiles, each carrying a plate of eggs, fried sausages and milk. Why are you here? Seeing the two women, a look of surprise appeared on Link's face. In fact, when they learned that Link was staying overnight at the base, they rushed over overnight. When we arrived, it was just after 6 in the morning. So, they went to prepare breakfast for Link without even sleeping. Don't ask these questions, just eat it quickly, otherwise it won't taste good when it gets cold. Twinkle urged Link. Daisy nodded in agreement. Yeah, there's not even a kitchen here. We spent a lot of effort to make this breakfast. You'd better eat it quickly. If it gets cold, I can't heat it up for you. Ah, well, Link stopped talking and started to eat heartily. Although he had already been fasting, he still wanted to satisfy his appetite. Seeing Link eating so happily, Twinkle and Daisy both smiled. Afterwards, the three of them ate and chatted. Daisy suddenly said, "By the way, the remnants of S.H.I.E.L.D. attacked again last night, but we dealt with them all." It turned out that after learning that Link had left the Triskelion building, the S.H.I.E.L.D. agents planned to launch a counterattack. But obviously, they underestimated the power of the mutants and were wiped out. Ever since Link openly accepted the allegiance of the mutants and became their leader. More and more mutants began to gather in Manhattan, all wanting to join the boys and become one of them. Last night, under the strong presence of Erica and Caliban, the major forces in Manhattan City have completed their initial integration. It can be said that after this round of integration, the boys have become the strongest mutant force in the entire Eagle Sauce, or even in the world. Just as Link was expanding his power, the outside world fell into an eerie silence. All information about the trial was deliberately blocked on that day. Whether it is traditional media or internet media, all relevant information has been blocked. Some people even tried to search for related words such as Homelander Link on the internet, but were surprised to find that they could not find any results. All the information about our motherland on the internet seemed to have been wiped out by some force overnight. This made many people start to think about it. Compared to the eerie silence of the outside world, Link's new home, the Triskelion building, has been unusually lively and crazy these days. Perhaps it was because Link became the leader of the mutants, his status and power were different from before, which made Flash develop a strong desire to conquer. You know, it's not just men who like to conquer women. Sometimes, women's desire to conquer is stronger than men's. Just imagine a man who is extremely powerful and can call the shots in the outside world. After returning home, you pressed me down and ravaged me. That sense of conquest, that sense of accomplishment, that sense of pleasure, it's even more addictive than anything else. Anyway, the flashing can't be controlled. She didn't care about Daisy, and these days she forced Link to try all kinds of positions in various places on the top floor of the building. As a result, these past few days, Daisy's eyes looked more and more strange when she looked at Link. Feeling frightened by Daisy's stare and unable to get away from Twinkle, Link simply returned to the Ultra Universe to have some peace and quiet. But no one expected that the situation in the Ultra Universe was also not peaceful. As soon as he came back, he received another call from Iruma K. Iruma K briefly reported on the meeting and tentatively invited Link to join the victory team. This is the first time. Link had no choice but to still reject Iruma K. Okay, honey, I respect your wishes. Iruma K was not discouraged. She just asked the question as usual, and it could be considered as an explanation to Sawai. After the communication was cut off, Link shook his head. I want to be the tiger of the victory team, not the cow of the victory team. Unconsciously, another week has passed. Link had a rare few days of comfortable life. She flirted with Iruma K at night and went to various entertainment venues during the day. Occasionally, I get to experience the unique culture of daily life, which is really cool. Huh, compared to the fighting and killing over at Marvel, it's really more comfortable here. Just as Link was sighing, Iruma K called him again. Quickly calling away the female technician who was helping him wash his feet, Link rubbed his cheeks with both hands, then turned on the communicator with a smile on his face. Dear, what can I do for you? Honey, please come to the headquarters, I need you now. Victory team, inside the operations commander's room. At this time, a round silver device lay quietly in the glass cover. Looking at the silver device, Link's mouth twitched slightly, revealing helplessness. May, is this what you mean by needing me? Upon hearing this, Iruma Wei blushed. She could tell the hidden meaning behind Link's words. This bad guy never does anything serious and just thinks about how to kill her all day long. She rolled her eyes at Link and said unhappily, "Be serious. I need your information." Link sighed softly. This woman was becoming increasingly difficult to trick. His eyes swept across the four unique symbols on the device, and he had some guesses in his mind. Link asked again, "Besides this device, have you made any other discoveries?" Iruma Wei nodded. "Yes, when we were digging for this device, we accidentally found a girl in black who had fainted. She has been taken back to the medical department for treatment." Link's eyes sparkled and he smiled, "I want to meet the girl in black first." If he guessed correctly, the girl in black was most likely Sake. "Well, you come with me." Ikuma Wei led the way in front. The Far East headquarters has many departments and even more staff, from scientific researchers to grassroots employees, who together maintain this huge organization. The headquarters has complete facilities, including living areas and medical areas. While leading the way, Iruma Wei gave Link an introduction to the department structure and personnel positions of the Far East headquarters. With the explanation of Iruma K, Link's understanding of TPC gradually deepened. The two of them hurried through the corridor and quickly arrived at the medical area, which was also the medical department. As soon as the door was opened, the smell of disinfectant hit me in the face, and at the same time, a busy and pretty nurse came into view. She was wearing simple work clothes, holding medical documents and a thermometer in her hands, with a frown on her face, revealing a little uneasiness. She is Shinjo's younger sister Mayumi. "What's going on here?" Link asked quietly. Hearing the voice, Mayumi turned around immediately. When she saw Wei Iruma following behind Link, she mistakenly thought that Link was also a senior member of the Victory Team, and her attitude immediately became respectful. In the Far East headquarters, the Victory Team has a high status and even ordinary team members are highly respected. "It's like this patient's temperature is abnormal, only 31 degrees, I wonder if there is something wrong with the thermometer." Mayumi hurriedly explained, secretly observing Link from time to time, and felt relieved when she saw that he was not angry. At this moment, Link's eyes fell on the girl in the hospital bed. The girl was wearing a black dress, her black hair was like a waterfall, and there was a golden flute-shaped pendant hanging around her neck, making her look mysterious and elegant. "This is the cosmic girl who has lived for countless years, Sake. No need to test again, this temperature is normal for her." Link shook his head. "What?" Mayumi opened her mouth in surprise, obviously unable to understand this statement. How could a normal person's body temperature be only 31 degrees? Iruma Wei frowned. "Isn't this girl a normal person?" "Well, you guessed it right." After getting Link's confirmation, Iruma Hui's expression instantly became alert. "Don't worry, she's not a bad person." Link explained. "She is just a poor homeless person." Out of trust in Link, Iruma K also relaxed his guard, and the tension in his heart immediately dissipated. When she saw Link, Sake seemed to sense something and a hint of fear appeared on her pretty face, which made her look quite pitiful. Link walked up to Sake and asked with a hint of doubt, "Is that device used in conjunction with the flute on your neck to summon monsters?" Hearing Link's words, Sake's eyes flashed with surprise. "This is a secret that belongs to her alone. How did this man know?" How did you know?" Sake's voice trembled. "Don't worry about how I know it, I just know it." Link said meaningfully, "This flute, combined with that capsule device, can summon the space monster Machina." Sake lowered her head, feeling uneasy. She knew the strength of the Victory Team, and now that her identity had been exposed, she didn't know what fate she would face next. "Ms. Sake, regarding the Machina you summoned, I am convinced that it has no ill intentions and the threat it poses to humans is just a misunderstanding. I am willing to assist you and ensure that everything is safe." Link's tone was gentle, like a spring breeze. "Thank you very much for your trust." Saki's eyes sparkled with gratitude. "But, do you really think Machina?" "Yes, I trust you. For safety reasons, I suggest that you and the capsule device be temporarily moved to the suburbs. After all, the environment there is more suitable for our observation and communication. Link interrupted Saki's doubts. Sake was stunned for a moment, then nodded, "Okay, I'll listen to you." Iruma Wei walked up to Link and asked quietly, "Honey, is this really okay?" "Believe me, Makina is not a threat. As long as we give it enough tolerance and understanding, we can avoid unnecessary conflicts." Link looked determined. Iruma Wei nodded. "Okay, I believe you." Afterwards, she issued a transfer order, and the members of the victory team quickly took action. Looking at the busy team members, Saki's heart was filled with gratitude. She turned to look at Link, her eyes twinkling, "Thank you, Link." Link laughed dumbly. "You don't have to thank me. Everything has a cause and an effect. It is your kindness that has created all this." Hearing Link praising her like that, Sake felt an inexplicable surge of joy in her heart. She didn't know how to express it, and then, under everyone's astonished gaze, she took the initiative to kiss Link's cheek. "Link, you are such a good man." Link was stunned when suddenly attacked, and Iruma Kei beside him was also stunned. "You flirt with my man in front of me." However, after seeing Saki's clear eyes, Iruma Kei could no longer feel angry. Because she knew the other party didn't mean it. This is indeed the case. Sake didn't have any distracting thoughts about Link. She just wanted to express her gratitude purely. It's just that the way of expression is a little bit different from ordinary people. Seeing this, Mayumi quietly pulled Shinjo's sleeve and said, "Brother, who is that Link? He looks so powerful, as if he knows everything, and he's also very friendly. I've taken care of Sake for so long, but she's never kissed me." At this point, Mayumi became a little jealous. Shinjo stole a glance at Iruma Kei, and after making sure that he hadn't noticed them, he whispered, "Mr. Link's background is very mysterious, and he has a lot of unknown information, but more importantly, he is our captain's male idol." Mayumi covered her mouth in shock. "Nani, the male actor of the captain? Keep your voice down, if the captain hears us we'll be in trouble." Shincheng quickly covered his sister's mouth, and then nervously glanced in the direction of Iruma Wei. He was relieved to find that the other party did not hear it. "It's good that you know about this, but don't spread it around, or we'll be in trouble." After solemnly instructing his sister, Shincheng and Dagu and others began to transfer their work. It took half a day. The transfer was finally completed successfully. Sake settled down in a quiet place in the suburbs. The other side, the victory team's big move soon alarmed the top management. After hearing this, Yoshioka was filled with doubts and quickly asked his subordinate Gondo, "Is this Lord Link's arrangement?" Gondo straightened up and answered, "Yes, all of this was arranged by Lord Link, and Captain Junji was just following the arrangements." Yoshioka waved his folding fan lightly and frowned. He is a suspicious person. Although Link has proven his ability many times, he has been slapped in the face by Link many times because of this. However, he still couldn't change his suspicious character. Link took matters into his own hands. Gondo hesitated. "Director, what should we do next?" "Go to the command room. I want to ask clearly." Yoshioka gave the order decisively. Although he believed in Link's abilities, he still had doubts about Link's origins. What's more, the girl can summon space monsters, which concerns the safety of the Earth, so he has to treat it with caution. Inside the operations commander's room, Iruma Kea also had doubts, but not about Link, but about Sake. Then, she instructed Yi Rui. "Yi Rui, can you use the flute pendant and the girl as clues to conduct a large-scale data investigation?" "No problem, Captain." Yi Rui responded quickly and started operating the computer. In less than 2.5 seconds, four photos appeared on the big screen. The first one is a photo taken in 1878. The image of Sake wearing a kimono matches the current image, and the flute pendant is exactly the same. Next, there are photos from 1946 and 1972, in which Saki's features are clearly visible, as if time has stopped for her. The last one is an illustration from an old book, depicting a spherical instrument and a girl in a Japanese-style portrait. Hori recognized the spherical instrument as the mysterious device called capsule that they had unearthed. Hori exclaimed, "This is exactly the same as the capsule device. I didn't expect what Link said was true. This girl really lived that long. Iruma K sighed, full of curiosity about the secret of Saki's immortality. At this moment, the door of the command room slowly opened. Yoshioka walked over steadily, waving his folding fan in his hand, and said seriously, "Captain Jujian, I heard that you have arranged for the girl to be sent to the suburbs and are planning to summon a monster there. I am skeptical about this arrangement. It's not that I don't trust Lord Link, but I can't rely on the kindness of monsters for the safety of the Earth." Yoshioka spoke with great force. Iruma K looked at Nori and motioned for him to continue. Nori continued to operate the computer, playing the historical archived video footage again and comparing it with Saki's footage. "I think these evidences are enough to prove everything. They are almost consistent with the information provided by Link. So when he says that the monster has no ill intentions, I believe him." Iruma K responded to Yoshioka's question calmly. In her heart, she was inclined towards Link. After all, Sake has lived for more than 200 years, but she has not been found to have done anything harmful to humanity. This is enough to prove that Sake has no ill will towards humans. Yoshioka frowned, obviously in a dilemma. All the evidence shows that Link is right, but the suspicious Yoshioka still insists on his opinion. "It's not that he's paranoid, but he's cautious. I personally approve of Mr. Link, but when it comes to the safety of the Earth, I can't just listen to his one-sided words." Yoshioka refused to give in. Iruma Wei frowned. "What do you think?" "My method is very simple, that is." 2.5 hours passed quickly. The outskirts of the Boso Peninsula were already bustling with activity. Under Yoshioka's arrangement, everyone was busy setting up a temporary command tent, while also placing various precision instruments and TPC armored tanks in an orderly manner. The Victory Swallow landed smoothly and the hatch slowly opened. Link walked out of the cabin steadily, followed by Iruma K and Sake. As his eyes swept across the neatly arranged tank company, Link's lips curled up slightly, revealing a barely perceptible hint of mockery. "It looks like Chief Yoshioka is very well prepared. It seems to be praise on the surface, but it is actually sarcasm. Because what will happen next will be another face-slapping plot that everyone loves to see." The other side, Gondo hurried over to Yoshioka and reported in a low voice, "Chief, everything has been arranged." Yoshioka nodded in satisfaction after hearing that, then looked at Link with a smile. Their eyes met briefly, then quickly looked away, as if they were competing in secret. Looking at the scene in front of him, Iruma Wei frowned, "Will this really not cause misunderstanding? Those instruments are fine, but the tank company might make the monsters mistake us for enemies." "Don't worry, I'm here," Link said firmly. "If a conflict arises, I will come forward to clean up the mess." Iruma Wei nodded. With Link's assurance, she felt much more at ease. After Yoshioka finished arranging the tanks, the Victory team's mission turned to ensuring the safety of Sake and the capsule device. As everyone watched, Sake nervously picked up the flute pendant, took a deep breath, and blew it. As the beautiful flute sounded, the capsule device slowly opened, shining with golden light, and finally turned into a beam of blue light that shot straight into the sky. About 2.5 minutes passed. The Delta Space Station captured a meteorite that was falling towards the Earth at a very fast speed. Yi Rui quickly spread the news to everyone. "The target is expected to land in 25 minutes, in an uninhabited area in the suburbs." Everyone on the Victory team glanced at Yoshioka, with a hint of sarcasm on their faces, as if they had foreseen that Yoshioka was going to be slapped in the face again. After listening to the report, Yoshioka's expression became more solemn, and he subconsciously clenched the folding fan in his hand. As time passed, everyone looked up at the sky and waited quietly. At this moment, a meteor streaked across the sky. Boom, followed by a loud bang and billowing smoke and dust. The meteor eventually fell in a distant area. After the smoke and dust gradually dissipated, an oval object similar to a pangolin slowly appeared. Then, the oval opened, revealing Makina's true appearance. Although he looks a bit ugly, Makina's behavior shows a kind of naivety. "I saw it scratching its head, as if it was curious about its surroundings. Then, it seemed to sense something, and with a cry of joy, it ran towards the suburbs where Sake was with a cheerful step. The monster is running towards us. It's not destroying the environment along the way, but it's very fast. It will arrive in about 2.5 minutes. Hori stared at the monitor screen and reported nervously. On the screen, the red dot representing Machina was approaching at an astonishing speed and was expected to arrive here soon. After hearing this report, Yoshioka showed hesitation, not knowing whether he should give the order to attack the monster. At this moment, Link said nonchalantly, "Chief Yoshioka, isn't the tank company you deployed used to deal with monsters? Why don't you order an attack now?" As soon as these words were spoken, everyone on the victory team looked towards Yoshioka. Of course they could hear the teasing in Link's tone. "You, Yoshioka, went to so much trouble before, but you failed at the critical moment. Isn't that just pure nonsense?" Yoshioka himself knew that Link's words were meant to insult him. He also wanted to order an attack, but the monster had not shown any aggressiveness so far and had not caused any casualties. This made him a failure in his career. It's easy to deal with at normal times, but when you see a monster, just start fighting. But this time it's different, because Link has revealed in advance that the monster is not dangerous at all. With this premise, Yoshioka must have a legitimate reason before he can issue an attack order. "Ahem, if the monster intends to attack, I will naturally take action." Yoshioka coughed a few times and tried to remain calm. Link smiled slightly and said nothing more, but his expression seemed to say, "Can you do it, little dog?" The other side. The muzzle of the armored tank was aimed at the speeding Machina. As the Machina approached the tank company, its speed gradually slowed down and finally stopped 100 meters away from the tank company. It scratched its face with its claws and blinked, as if looking for something. Yoshioka's heart tightened when he saw this, and he had a feeling that things would most likely develop as Link said. He turned to look at Link, who smiled a meaningful smile. Yoshioka quickly turned around and ordered Gondo to remain on guard, but he was deeply impressed by Link's intelligence ability. Well, let him be slapped in the face. He is used to it anyway. The most important thing is to ensure the safety of the Earth. The other side, Sake stepped forward with joy and called out to the monster, "Machina, stay where you are and don't move. I'll be right there." Hearing Sake's voice transmission, Machina nodded obediently, folded her paws in front of her like a praying person, and really waited there. Hum. At this moment, the flute pendant on Saki's chest suddenly burst into dazzling light. Then, she was surrounded by divine light and landed lightly on Maki's overlapping giant claws. Sake conveyed her gratitude to Link through telepathy, "Thank you, Link. This is a small farewell gift from me. Please accept it as a testimony to our friendship." As soon as the words fell, a ball of brilliant light floated out from Saki's body and finally slowly landed in front of Link. There was a flash of surprise in Link's eyes, and then he reached out and took the ball of light. Ding. Energy X1 detected, do you want to absorb it? Absorb. Ding. The energy has been absorbed and converted into genetic energy by 70 million calories. The energy limit has exceeded 3,000 million calories. Ding. Due to the influence of this energy, you have evolved superpowers, immortality cells. Ding. Since the immortal cells are of the same origin as Man of Steel 3, they have been autonomously fused into superpower, God Man of Steel. Hiss. This is a great gift. Link himself did not expect such an unexpected gain, and a look of surprise immediately appeared on his face. Sure enough, good deeds will be rewarded. If everyone was like Sake, he wouldn't have to fight and kill all day long. Seeing that Link seemed very satisfied, Saki's smile became even brighter. Then, she looked at Dagu and said, "Dagu, I also want to thank you. It was you who saved me and brought me back to the victory team, so I had the opportunity to meet Link." As she spoke, she also gave Dajiyu a ball of light as a thank you. Looking at Saki's appearance, Dagu recalled that distant childhood in his mind, when he was riding a car and met that mysterious sister on the beach. She once said that she was waiting here for someone to take her home. Those vague memories became unusually clear at this moment. "Everyone, we'll meet again if we're lucky." As Sake waved goodbye, Machina's shell completely closed, as if it had transformed into a spaceship and took off into the sky, eventually disappearing into the depths of space. Chapter 91. This, is it over? Yoshioka looked at this scene in amazement. Link stretched and jokingly asked, "What else?" These words, like a loud slap in the face, slapped Yoshioka hard. "Well, I got slapped in the face again." Not long after, communication came from the Delta Space Station, indicating that Machina had indeed moved away from the Earth and flew into the unknown depths of the universe. After getting the confirmation, Yoshioka felt embarrassed but secretly relieved at the same time. Take these things away. Yes, Yoshioka asked Gondo to stay and clean up the mess, and he left in a hurry. Now that things have come to an end, I should go back. Link winked at Irumake and prepared to turn around and leave to continue the second half of the foot washing. Irumake said, I might be working late today, so you can take care of dinner yourself. Well, I will. Just as Link was about to leave, Dagu approached him and said, Link, let me take you there. In fact, sending Link off was a lie. Dagu's real purpose was to ask for advice from the other party. Watching the two people leave side by side, Irumake suddenly frowned. She didn't know if it was an illusion, but she always felt that Dajiyu had some intentions towards Link. Moreover, how could these two people walking side by side give her a gay feeling? Not only Irumake, but also Lina beside her had the same illusion. She originally thought that she only had one competitor, Wei Nama. How come there is another Dagu now? Link and Dajiyu didn't know what the two women were thinking. If he knew, Dagu would probably be so angry that he would vomit blood. As for Link, hehe. If Dagu could change into his own shape, it would be exciting to think about it. On the car, Dagu carefully turned off the communication equipment in the car and carefully checked whether there was any monitoring. After confirming that it was safe, Dajiyu took a deep breath and asked, Link, will the number and harm of monsters continue to increase in the future? Was the destruction of the super ancient civilization 30 million years ago related to those monsters? Link glanced at him sideways, a hint of surprise flashing in his eyes. Why are you asking this all of a sudden? In the original drama, Dagu seemed to have never had such deep thoughts. I had a nightmare these days. Dajiyu took a deep breath, his voice trembling slightly. In my dream, I was swallowed by endless darkness, sinking into the abyss of the ocean, sinking in fear and despair. At first I thought it was just a nightmare, but gradually I realized that it might not just be a nightmare, but some kind of omen. At this moment, he finally had the opportunity to express the worries that had been buried in his heart. Link's eyes narrowed when he heard that. If he guessed correctly, the scene that Dajiyu dreamed of should be the scene where the evil god Gatanja took away Tiga's light and then turned into a stone statue and sank to the bottom of the sea. Dagu, the scene you dreamed of might be the scene of the evil god Gatanja destroying the world, or it might be the disaster that Tiga experienced 30 million years ago. Dajiyu was shocked when he heard this, and his face showed unprecedented tension, the evil god Gatanja. Does that mean I will be killed by it in the future and repeat the mistakes of Tiga? He recalled the feeling of powerlessness in the nightmare, the despair of being unable to stop the disaster, and his heart was filled with fear. Link shook his head. You don't have to scare yourself. The future can be changed. As the saying goes, all fear comes from lack of strength. To put it bluntly, the reason you're afraid is that you don't have confidence in your own abilities. In that case, then go and improve your strength. Well, I promised you before that I would help you improve your strength, so let's start tonight. Every night at 10 o'clock, I will take you to do practical training and help you improve your strength as quickly as possible. Link pointed to the communicator in his hand, but I'm usually very busy at night, so you have to remember to notify me in advance. Hearing this, Dagu's eyes lit up and he said excitedly, Really? That's great, I will definitely work hard. It was 9:50, just before nightfall. Dajiyu had already informed Link in advance, and he also came to the suburbs, quietly waiting for Link's arrival. In the victory team, I will be the first person to be trained by Link himself. If Shincheng and the others knew about this, they would probably be envious to death. A sense of anticipation welled up in Dagu's heart. 10 o'clock arrived quickly. Suddenly, a beam of bright lightning fell from the sky, extremely conspicuous in the dark night. Sorry to have kept you waiting, Dagu. The lightning faded, and Link emerged. Dagu's eyes sparkled. Link, let's get started quickly, my magic stick is thirsty. Okay, very spirited. Link's mouth curled up. In that case, I won't waste any more words. The training will officially begin now and will last for half an hour. After saying this, Link took out his cell phone, turned on the timer inside and started counting. According to the plan, he would not personally take part in the initial stage of practical training. He planned to let the energy life form take action, so that the training intensity would not be too high, and it would be a chance for Dagu to adapt. Only after Dagu has completely adapted can we give him the real tough work. Learn. Dagu quickly took out the Aoki stick and transformed into a human-sized Tiga. Seeing this, Link sent out the Hulk in the first battle. Dajiyu was not surprised to see the Hulk appear. Because he had already guessed it before, he knew that the Marvel clan was most likely related to Link. Dajiyu assumed a fighting stance and stood opposite the Hulk. After the two confronted each other for 2.5 seconds, Dajiyu took the lead in launching the attack, rushing forward without hesitation and opening fire on the Hulk with full force. This was also Link's order. Even though it was just training, we had to give it our all. Sure enough, there is something. Link nodded secretly, affirming Dagu's strength. The protagonist is the protagonist. Even without systematic training, he has become so much stronger in a short period of time. However, if he wants to defeat the Hulk, Dajiyu is still a little short of what he needs. The reason why Link sent out the Hulk instead of other energy life forms was not only to test Dagu's melee strength. More importantly, it is to help Dagu hone his combat skills and accumulate combat experience. Link is very much looking forward to Dajiyu being able to achieve self-transcendence in battle, integrating various fighting techniques and forming his own unique fighting style. He also firmly believed that Dagu could do it. Boom. While Link was thinking, Dajiyu and the Hulk had already started a fierce collision. Although the Hulk is stronger, Tiga is not at all weaker. He used his skills to make up for his lack of strength, and even someone as strong as the Hulk was unable to overpower Daiko. The two collided violently again and again. The terrifying aftermath caused the ground to tremble and flattened the surrounding trees. The two men's battle was like a collision between Mars and the Earth, and the fight gradually entered a white-hot stage. A few days later, the setting sun shone on the courtyard, creating mottled light and shadows. Link lazily lay in the rocking chair, and Irumake was cleaning her things on the side. Her pretty face was rosy and shiny, obviously she had been well irrigated. However, it was so full that it all leaked out. Look at you, you got all over my clothes, and I have an emergency meeting to attend later. Irumake gave Link a reproachful look. This fool ignored her pleas and insisted on getting it all over her clothes. It would take at least an hour to clean and dry it now, and I would be late for the meeting. Oh, now you blame me. You were the one who asked me to leave it outside, and I did it. It was you who failed to catch it. Link glanced at her and said, "Your own problem, shouldn't you reflect on yourself?" Hearing this, Irumake was so angry at Link's shamelessness that he laughed. When they were in love, Link was obedient to her like a little puppy. Now, it has become a big wolf dog, no, it has become a honey badger. HMPH, just wait for me, I'll deal with you when I come back tonight. Irumake glared at Link fiercely, then took the packed clothes and went out to find a cleaning shop. Link said disdainfully, how can a defeated general talk about courage? However, after Irumake left, he was once again in a state of having nothing to do. Suddenly, he felt an urge to go to the amusement park. The impulse came suddenly. Link frowned in confusion. Why did this thought suddenly come to his mind? Could it be related to the upcoming plot? My super intuition sensed in advance that the amusement park monster Gotti is about to be born. With this in mind, Link decided to follow his instincts and find something fun to relieve his boredom. Link quickly changed into casual clothes, then activated his speed force and set off briskly. After a while, he arrived at his destination. The amusement park is crowded with people and has many attractions. Link bought the ticket and entered. He looked around and was immediately attracted by the gloomy haunted house. I hope you can give me some excitement. Link entered the haunted house and saw the dark environment, flashing colorful lights, and lingering eerie music, which made people nervous and scared. But Link remained calm and composed, completely ignoring the gloomy scene before him. As he turned the corner, he saw a female ghost in a white dress suddenly appear. The female ghost in the white dress lowered her head, her long hair like a waterfall, covering most of her face, leaving only a pair of dark eyes exposed, looking eerie in the dim light. Link raised his eyebrows slightly, his heart calm. He ignored the female ghost in the white dress and continued walking forward. Ah, looking at Link walking past her, the female ghost disguised as a haunted house employee was confused at this moment, with a thousand horses galloping through her heart. As the number one person who is scared of haunted houses, this was the first time she encountered such a situation, and her cerebellum was almost atrophied. Is her makeup not scary enough? Or was her performance lacking? No, I can't give up like this. The female ghost was unwilling to accept the result, so she decided to follow Link and wait for an opportunity to find his buttocks. I don't believe I can't scare you. However, Link in front seemed unaware and allowed the female ghost to follow him. When they came to a narrow passage, the wall suddenly fell down, revealing a coffin and a vampire inside. The vampire fell down at an angle, his eyes wide open, his fangs exposed, and blood seemed to be flowing. But surprisingly, Link remained expressionless and even seemed to want to laugh. He looked at the vampire calmly, as if he were looking at a mentally retarded person. What? The vampire was also confused. Seeing Link staring at him expressionlessly, he suddenly felt creepy. Who the hell is the ghost? The vampire cursed inwardly and quickly shrank back into the coffin. Hey, do you have any professional ethics? I bought the ticket, how can you shrink back? Come out and scare me. Link slapped the coffin with a look of dissatisfaction. The vampire hiding in the coffin was cursing Shen Jingbing in his heart. If you meet a pervert like this, he won't come out even if you kill him. A vampire's life is not a life. That's boring. Seeing that the vampire refused to come out, Link had no choice but to leave. This scene made the female ghost following behind dumbfounded. She had never seen anyone so desperate. What? At this moment, a scream spread throughout the haunted house. Link paused, knowing that this was the beginning of the plot. So, he turned around and said to the female ghost behind him, "Stop following me like a pervert. Go back." What? Am I a pervert? The female ghost widened her eyes. This was the first time she was called a pervert since she started working, and her mentality exploded instantly. When the ghost girl came to her senses, Link had disappeared. Begalu, I wish you and your family happiness. The female ghost's defense was broken immediately, and she could only leave with a frustrated mood and cursing. The other side, Xincheng, who was wearing a neat suit, was lying on the bench in a mess, his face pale and sweating, as if he had just experienced a serious illness. Ha ha ha, Nissan, you are so timid. You were frightened to the point of begging for mercy and almost fainted. Mayumi couldn't help but laugh out loud, her eyes twinkling with mischief. As a member of the victory team, you can't behave like this. Xincheng stubbornly said, I wasn't really scared, I was just acting to match the haunted house. Do you really think a mere ghost can scare me? Ah, yes, yes, you are the bravest. Mayumi said with a half smile. Hearing the teasing in his sister's tone, Xincheng felt both frustrated and angry. Hey, Mayumi, can you please stop making fun of me in front of Lord Link and save some face for me, your brother? It turned out that the scream just now came from Xincheng. Link rushed over when he heard the sound, so the three of them met in the haunted house. Xincheng, what you said is wrong. Link taught him a lesson. Of course I have to give you face, but sometimes you lose it yourself. Mayumi smiled and agreed, I agree. Humph, your elbow is really bent outward. Looking at the two people slandering him in unison, Xincheng turned his head away in annoyance, like a little child throwing a tantrum. Link almost died of laughter at this guy. At this moment, Mayumi asked curiously, Sir, why are you not afraid at all? And you are walking around in a haunted house with a female ghost, so gay. Link laughed dumbly. This is the difference in our concepts. Different ideas. Mayumi was puzzled when she heard this, and Xinjo also looked confused. That's right. Just like when you were little, your aunt told you that ghosts are scary. Even if the ghosts don't come to bite you, you'll still be scared to death. But if we can reverse this concept, then ghosts are just like shit. They look disgusting and smell bad, but they are actually harmless to you. Link's words are full of philosophy. Xinjo and Mayumi were stunned upon hearing this. I don't know if I felt hungry after listening to it. Xincheng swallowed and said, after listening to your words, I feel enlightened. Link glanced at Xincheng and found that this guy was actually swallowing his saliva when he heard the word shit. Why are you still greedy? Are you the eighth from Xincheng? Xincheng didn't know what Link was thinking. Now he said with a dejected look on his face, alas, today's holiday is ruined. It's such a waste of my precious time. Mayumi heard this, but added, Brother, you don't have a girlfriend, you are just a single dog, why are you afraid of wasting your time? Xincheng's mouth twitched and he covered his chest with his hands, feeling as if his heart was stabbed by a knife. Did you say that? Sure enough, lies won't hurt, the truth is the sharpest knife. Xincheng was so stabbed that he had no words to say, so he simply turned his head away and ignored his stupid sister. Seeing Xincheng being upset again, Link almost couldn't hold it in. He is such an adult, but he still acts like a child. I really admire him. Xincheng, your temper is worse than that of a child. You are probably only slightly better than those two naughty kids. Link said, pointing to the two children in the distance, as if hinting at something. In sight, two naughty kids are bullying a little boy. And a cute little girl is trying to stop them. Don't bully my brother. But her efforts to stop it didn't seem to have much effect. The two naughty kids still bully the little boy. I'll take care of these two kids. New Town hates bullying the most. So, without saying a word, he rushed forward, ready to uphold justice. Hey, you two little brats, why are you bullying others? Seeing the menacing Xincheng, the two naughty kids were immediately scared away. It seems that the plot is about to begin. Link had a playful look on his face, Mayumi, I have something to do and I'm leaving first. Please tell your brother for me. After saying goodbye to Mayumi, Link followed the two naughty kids. After about 2.5 minutes, on a lawn somewhere, a huge horn flashing with blue arcs suddenly appeared. Oh, what is this? One of the naughty kids, dressed in black, reached out to touch it with a curious look on his face. Don't be naughty. At this moment, Link's voice was heard, and the naughty boy immediately stopped. Then, Link deliberately released a little telekinesis, and an invisible pressure descended, which frightened the naughty kids and they quickly left in terror. This is how you treat naughty kids. Next, it's your turn, the bear monster. Looking at the huge horn, Link could feel the enormous energy contained in it. He took out his communicator and quickly contacted Iruma K. The other side, Far East Headquarters, the atmosphere in the operations commander's room was relaxed. There is no other way. After all, no monsters have appeared during this period of time, so it is hard for the victory team to be idle. Otherwise, Xincheng wouldn't have a day off today. Speaking of which, it's a bit hard to get used to these peaceful days. Hori uttered a Versailles exclamation. Iruma Wei said unhappily, isn't this good enough? Must we fight and kill? Before she finished her words, her communicator suddenly rang and she quickly took it out and answered it. A big banana, a big banana. As soon as the bell rang, everyone immediately restrained their expressions and became serious. Because this is the unique ringtone when Link calls. And every time he called, it meant something big was about to happen. The screen of the communicator flashed, and then a huge horn appeared in front of everyone. This is the monster's horn, currently located in Ginza Amusement Park. Link's voice came, without any extra nonsense. Iruma K immediately looked at Nori and ordered, lock down Ginza Amusement Park and issue an emergency evacuation notice immediately. Yes, Yi Rui operated the computer with a serious face. At this moment, a dazzling light suddenly shot out from the horn, and yellow particle energy quickly gathered at the tip of the horn and rushed straight into the sky. When the energy beam reached a certain height, it began to spread rapidly and formed a semicircular rainbow light shield, instantly covering the entire amusement park. This is, Iruma Hui's face changed, and he asked anxiously, Link, are you okay over there? I'm fine here for now. Link looked around and saw curious people gathering around him. Not far away, the new city was rushing towards them. Sir Link, I see you are here. I was just looking for you. Xincheng said nervously, I saw an invisible barrier blocking the entire amusement park. Is it the work of this giant horn? What is it? Is it a monster? Link nodded and said, yes, you guessed it right. This thing is the horn of the barrier monster Gazi, no, Gadi. Barrier monster Gadi, Xincheng was shocked when he heard this. Iruma Wei also hurriedly asked, Link, do you have any way to deal with this monster? Use liquid nitrogen. Link gave his own advice. Liquid nitrogen should be able to break down Gadi's barrier. Besides, Gadi's target is the children. Xincheng, you should quickly evacuate the children and take them to a safe place. Iruma-kei's voice came, "Shinjo, just follow Link's instructions." "Yes, Captain." Shinjo didn't hesitate at all. After receiving the order, he took action and organized the evacuation of the children with Mayumi. Ho ho ho. At this moment, a deafening roar came from underground, and the earth seemed to be shaking. Boom. The giant horn sank slowly like a devil's claw in the abyss, and the ground collapsed like torn cloth, forming a huge pit. Seeing this, Link retreated hastily. Two tentacles suddenly flew out from the huge pit, trying to capture the children nearby. "Did you ask me if I arrested someone in front of me?" Link narrowed his eyes and instantly activated his speed force. The world seemed to stand still. Link entered the time dilation realm and transformed into a beam of orange lightning. He quickly rescued the children who were attacked by the tentacles and took them away from the danger zone. Time returns to normal. The monster's tentacles were still spreading rapidly, but all its attacks missed. Gotti, who was underground, was stunned when he saw this scene. "The duck that was in my mouth suddenly flew away. What's even more outrageous is that it didn't even see how the duck flew away." At the same time, Gotti's desire to lay eggs became stronger and stronger, and it could no longer suppress it. Roar! It broke through the ground with a crack, and its violent roar shook the entire amusement park. Then, it quickly searched for the children in the garden, and when it saw them all gathered at the edge of the barrier, greed immediately flashed in its eyes. However, among this group of children, suddenly a Link appeared. Although Link is very small in size, the terrifying biological force field he exudes makes Gotti feel an unprecedented threat. "Human, you were the one who stopped me just now." Gotti roared towards the sky, and then an angry voice came into Link's mind. The mind-reading technique took effect quietly, allowing the conversation between the two parties to proceed smoothly. Link was walking through the panicked crowd, trying his best to comfort the children, and had no time to pay attention to Gotti. "You fool, how dare you ignore me?" Seeing this scene, Gotti became furious, and swung his pink tentacles like a whip, smashing towards Link fiercely. Boom! The earth collapsed and the aftermath was turbulent. However, Gotti felt a sense of emptiness, as if the tentacles did not touch any entity. It retracted its tentacles, and the ground was cracked with gullies, but there was no sign of Link. Gotti was confused and kept looking for Link. Snapped. Suddenly, a snap of fingers broke the silence. Gotti looked in the direction of the sound and saw that Link had arrived in front of it without anyone noticing. At this moment, Link was like the dazzling sun, with colorful light all over his body, as if a god had descended. "If you want to deal with me, you have to get past them first." As Link finished his words, five colorful beams of light rose up and five giant energy life forms appeared out of thin air. Shincheng looked at this scene and felt indescribable shock in his heart. At this moment, Link exuded an indescribable holy light, as if the whole world was under his control. Under the cover of colorful light, Gotti suddenly lowered his head, his beast eyes flashing with a violent light, as if he wanted to destroy everything. The giant horn on its head was gathering energy, and the horn gradually became transparent, with orange electric current surging inside. Finally, the giant horn shot out a beam of orange-red light, shooting towards one of the energy life forms. Nisunai, facing Gotti's beam attack, Link immediately gave the five people an attack order. Wolverine, Hulk, Storm, Mr. Fantastic, Invisible Woman, take turns giving me a word. After receiving the order, the five people immediately took action. First, the Invisible Woman released an invisible shield to block Gotti's destructive beam. After that, the remaining four men quickly approached and beat him fiercely from four directions. There was a flash of light in Wolverine's hand, and his adamantium claw stretched out, slashing down at Gotti's body. Clang! Gotti's huge horns clashed with the wolf's claws, causing a roar of metal clashing. After the roar, Gotti was actually forced back several steps by Wolverine and let out a painful howl. Because in the previous confrontation, a piece of his huge horn was cut off by the wolf's claws. "You guys, are they all new members of the Marvel clan? They're too strong." When Shincheng saw this scene, he was so shocked by Wolverine's strength that his mouth opened wide. The other side. Inside the operations commander's room. A new Marvel member has appeared. Hori was shocked when he saw this. Not only him, but other members of the victory team were also deeply shocked. It seems that our previous speculation about the Marvel clan was not entirely correct. Zongfeng's face was full of seriousness. The Marvel clan is not a super ancient race with few members and almost extinct. TPC experts have studied the Marvel clan and believe that they may be a super ancient race on the verge of extinction, just like the Giants of Light. However, today's new appearances of Wolverine and the Fantastic Two have overturned the experts' conclusions. Is the Marvel clan going to announce to the world that their race is about to return? Ikuma Hui's expression was solemn, and he subconsciously thought about this. Captain, the Marvel clan has contained the monsters. Taking this opportunity, please send someone to break the barrier as soon as possible and evacuate the children safely. At this moment, Xincheng's urgent voice came from the communicator. Okay, I'll arrange it right away. Iruma K decisively ordered. Munakata, Daiko, fire the liquid nitrogen beam. Yes, the two responded quickly and pressed the launch button, and a beam of blue light hit the barrier directly. Click, click, click. After about 2.5 seconds, the barrier gradually broke apart and finally turned into fragments and dissipated. Nice. Liquid nitrogen really can break down the barrier. Link's information is correct. Dagu waved his arms excitedly. Inside the operations commander's room. Great. Hori also jumped up excitedly and subconsciously patted Nori's back. Hiss. After being slapped in the back for no reason, Nori looked at Hori with resentment, like a wronged young wife. Munakata, Daiko, support the Marvel clan immediately and help them deal with the monsters. Seeing that the barrier problem had been solved, Ikuma Wei quickly issued a second order. The other side, after being beaten up by 5 people, Gotti was completely stunned. Huhu, it shook its dizzy head, trying to keep itself awake. At this time, it was covered with scars, its eyes were wide open, and it looked extremely miserable. If you don't know, you might think it was abused. Roar, Gotti roared angrily and swung his tentacles to lash out at the 5 people. However, the Hulk remained unmoved, stepped forward decisively, and grabbed the outstretched tentacle. He pulled hard, with such force that Gotti was caught off guard and stumbled forward. At this moment, a solar storm accompanied by lightning and thunder fell from the sky and shot towards Gotti below. Gotti reacted quickly, and the half-horn on his head emitted a destructive beam, which collided with the solar storm. Boom! The two energies exploded in midair, and terrifying waves spread, even distorting the space. Gotti was knocked over by the aftermath of the explosion. In anger and humiliation, he waved his tentacles to hit Mr. Fantastic Reed, who was standing beside him. But Reed just raised the corners of his mouth slightly, with a disdainful smile on his face. Bang! The tentacles hit Reed but did not cause any harm to him. He even used Reed's force to his advantage, turning himself into a spinning top and knocking Gotti to the ground with one punch. Seeing this opportunity, the invisible woman released a power field to suppress the fallen Gotti. The Hulk also jumped out at this time and pressed his entire body on Gotti. Under the double suppression, Gotti was immediately suppressed. At this moment, the claws in Wolverine's hands cut through the air like lightning and pierced into Gotti's head. Roar! He howled in pain, his eyes filled with anger and despair. At this moment, Storm also controlled lightning to strike, continuously paralyzing Gotti. It makes me want to curse the currency. Waves of violent electric currents came from the sky and instantly rushed into Gotti's body. The strong electric shock made him lose consciousness for a short time. Of course Wolverine would not miss this good opportunity. His claws thrust back and forth, making bloody holes in Gotti's head one after another. After stabbing for a full 2.5 minutes, Gotti finally stopped struggling, and his life force quickly dissipated. Ding! Energy X1 detected, do you want to absorb it? Absorb! Ding! The energy has been absorbed and converted into genetic energy by 60 million calories. The energy limit has exceeded 3,060 million calories. Ding! Due to the influence of this energy, you have evolved a superpower, Transparent Barrier. Ding! Since the Transparent Barrier and the Mental Barrier have the same origin, they have been autonomously integrated into a superpower, Absolute Barrier. Good! Link nodded, then withdrew his energy life form and ran away. New members of the Marvel Cinematic Universe have arrived. This news caused a huge stir within TPC. The top management immediately held an emergency meeting to discuss matters concerning the Marvel clan. Since the Marvel clan are friendly forces to humanity, the atmosphere at the meeting was not very tense. At this moment, a video of five Wolverine men beating up Gotti was playing on the screen. Everyone watched it frame by frame over and over again, and they were more and more amazed. With the joint efforts of five people, Gotti was beaten to death without even the slightest ability to fight back. Being tortured to death like this, even everyone felt that Gotti was a bit pitiful. At the same time, this also proves the power of the Marvel cinema from the side. These five people are very strong. Each one of them is no weaker than Golzin. After the video was finished, Hori was the first to sigh. In the victory team, the unit of measurement for combat power is Golzin. Currently, Tiga has the power of 2.5 Golzums. As for the motherland, it has the power of about 4 Golzums. The individual combat power of the Marvel clan may seem inferior to that of Ultraman, but they have more people. In terms of comprehensive combat power, the Marvel Cinematic Universe is clearly superior to Ultraman. What's even more terrifying is that every Marvel clan member possesses different superpowers. For example, Storm's Solar Storm, in terms of lethality alone, is even greater than Tiga's Zaperiod Ray. Yi Rui quickly tapped on the keyboard and displayed a series of data comparison charts for everyone. Everyone nodded in agreement. The power of a solar storm was indeed terrifying. Compared to superpowers, I am more concerned about the current number of Marvel people. So Yi looked at Iruma Kei and asked, "Can I get information about this from Lord Link?" Iruma Wei shook his head. "I asked, but Link said he didn't know much about the Marvel clan, so." Zijing sighed. "Okay. The origins of the Marvel clan seem to be shrouded in a mysterious fog, with very few clues. Even Link, who is known as a know-it-all, seems to know little about this mysterious, ultra-ancient race. However, Dagu has a different opinion. He actually noticed long ago that there seemed to be some connection between the Marvel clan and Link. But Link himself refused to admit it, so Dagu didn't dare to disclose the information without permission. After all, Link must have his reasons for doing this." Lina had a sudden idea, and her mind was opened. Perhaps, the Marvel people are not some super ancient race, nor are they cosmic people, but earthlings from another parallel universe. Hori thought about it and nodded. "It is possible. After all, after the Marvel clan became giant, their appearance still remained human, which seems to be different from Tiga's homeland." Zhang Feng also agreed. "Mr. K, this guess is not unreasonable." Reiko Kashiwamura proposed a hypothesis. "Perhaps, super ancient humans are like this, each of them has powerful superpowers, and modern humans are just degenerated." This hypothesis sparked heated debate among the public. Everyone imagines, what would the world be like if everyone had superpowers? However, Dagu and Yulian, who was listening in secret, were speechless. This assumption cannot be said to be groundless, it can only be said to be nonsense. At this time, Lina raised another question. "Looking at this situation, there will probably be more and more new Marvel members appearing in the future. When that happens, how should we treat them?" Xincheng wondered. "Aren't the Marvels friendly forces of mankind? How else can we treat them?" "Of course, we should treat them as friends." Zhang Feng shook his head. "It's not that simple. After all, positions can change at any time. They are friendly forces today, but who can guarantee that they will still be friendly forces tomorrow?" Hearing this, everyone fell silent for a moment. "Yes, who can guarantee this?" The other side. After reading the meeting report from Iruma Kei, a hint of amusement appeared on Link's lips. "I have to say, Lina has a pretty big imagination. But to be honest, Lina did guess some truths by accident. I can only say that she is worthy of being one of the heroines." While everyone was discussing the Marvel clan, the atmosphere in the Space Development Agency's laboratory was tense. Ryosuke Sanada, wearing a white protective suit and with his eyes covered by a blindfold, stared quietly at the meteorite isolated by special glass. This meteorite contains the magical Ebron cells. He was seen wearing isolation gloves, stroking the meteorite, with greed flashing in his eyes. After a period of biological experiments, he discovered that the effects of Ebron cells were extremely amazing. Not only can it evolve the physique, it can even evolve the brain, improving intelligence without limit. In his biological experiments, the intelligence of a monkey made great progress, and its intelligence was even equivalent to that of an adult. However, The experiment now faces a problem. That is, the power consumption is extremely huge. Once there is no sufficient power supply to maintain life and suppress side effects, then, this experiment cannot proceed at all. If I can continue to evolve, I will definitely become the strongest human in time. Ryosuke Sanada stroked the meteorite, his eyes full of ambition. I want to defeat Hori. I want to prove to everyone that I am the winning team. No, I am the most powerful brain in the entire human race. Ryosuke Sanada took a deep breath, quickly took off his gloves, and then opened the glass lid. His hand just stretched out towards the meteorite. The moment he touched the meteorite, a bright green light instantly lit up and spread to his palm in the blink of an eye. After a few seconds, the green light dissipated. The meteorite and Sanada Ryosuke's hand returned to normal. Although there seems to be no change, Ryosuke Sanada can clearly feel that there is a mysterious force wandering in his body, which is gradually transforming the cells. Next, it's time to evolve. Under night, the surrounding environment seems exceptionally peaceful. In this tranquility, fishing has become a leisure activity for many people, which can not only cultivate one's character but also kill time. A couple was fishing by the lake when suddenly they felt a strong tug on their fishing rod. It's hooked. Pull, the middle-aged woman shouted excitedly. The man quickly walked over to her, gripped the fishing rod tightly, and prepared to pull the fish ashore together. But at this moment, the power plant in the distance suddenly exploded, and the bright flames instantly illuminated the night sky. The couple exclaimed, "What?" The power plant exploded. At the same time, in the flames of the explosion, Ryosuke Sanada stood quietly, allowing his body to be engulfed by the sea of fire, madly absorbing the remaining electric current around him. His eyes flashed with a hint of coldness. "It's not enough, I need more electricity to help me climb to a higher peak. As long as there is enough electricity, I can surpass the Giant of Light from the Ultra family or the superheroes from the Marvel family." After absorbing the last bit of electricity, Ryosuke Sanada's gaze pierced through the sea of fire, looked towards the hotel in the distance, and then slowly left. Soon after, the ruins of a power plant by the sea. Victory Swallow Number 1 is galloping towards us. Daji Yu glanced around in the cockpit, but found nothing. "We have arrived at the designated location, but have not found anything, and the sensors have no abnormalities." Iruma Wei warned on the communicator, "Be careful. We did detect a strong biological energy reaction. Although it was only for a moment, this is most likely an unknown monster. During this period of monster outbreaks, this energy reaction undoubtedly reminds people of new monsters. Learn." Daji Yu made another round of inspection. However, this second inspection still yielded no findings. Such powerful biological energy should have been captured by our equipment. How could it suddenly disappear? Xincheng sat in the driver's seat, his brows furrowed, his tone full of confusion. Even if the monster awakens briefly from its slumber, but their infrared sensors should also be able to capture its traces. But now there is nothing. Well, since we have gained nothing, we can only go back and report. There was a hint of helplessness in Dagu's voice. Since nothing has been found here, it would be futile to continue searching. Victory Swallow Number 1 quickly returned to base. As soon as the two stepped into the command room, they heard Nori and Lina also reporting. But their results were the same as Dagu's, still no discoveries. "Leave this matter to me." At this time, Hori walked in with a briefcase and displayed 6 blue and gold canister-shaped bullets. "This is a new monster tracker I developed. Just hit the monster with it and it will continuously release particle signals. No matter where the monster flees, it can be tracked." Then, he took out another instrument. Combined with this small detector, it can easily locate the monster's position. Those areas that were previously undetectable by radar and sensors are no longer a problem with this tracker. A smug smile spread across Hori's face. Although he was a weak fighter, he was confident that no one could surpass him in weapons development. Daji Yu was pleasantly surprised and said, "Great. With this thing, it will be much easier for us to track monsters in the future." "Horui, good job." Shinjo also gave a thumbs up. "Horui, you must go to the scene immediately and start a new round of exploration." Iruma K admired Hori's talent and was glad that he had been recruited into the team. "Understood." Hori responded immediately. "Link is a person who knows how to balance work and rest. These days, he was either training Daegu or taming Urumake, which made him a little mentally exhausted. After all, delicious food will get boring if you eat it every day. Therefore, he would go from time to time to experience the customs and practices of various places, so as to relax his tired mind. Anyway, as long as he has Megumi Iruma in his heart, according to the theory of inequality, this is not considered as cheating. After overcoming this psychological barrier, Link began his journey of experience. For several days, he was immersed in the turbulent waves and couldn't extricate himself. Only after all his mental fatigue was gone did Link end this experience journey. With a full and relaxed spirit, I started my vacation in a hotel next to an open-air swimming pool. Link wore sunglasses and lazily lay on a beach chair, admiring the playful figures of the girls in swimsuits and enjoying this rare relaxation. Suddenly, a familiar figure came into his sight. It was Hori. At this time, he was holding the tracking device in his hand, but with a depressed expression on his face. "I've been searching for so long, but I still haven't found any clues. My tracker is useless unless the monster shows up." Hori complained helplessly and felt anxious about the progress of the mission. "Horibi, what are you doing here?" At this moment, Link called out to him. "Oh, it's Lord Link. What a coincidence. I didn't expect to see you here." The moment he saw Link, Hori's eyes lit up and he quickly walked over to try to get close to him. "Mr. Link, I have something to ask you. You want to ask me about the new monsters?" Link shook his head. "I'm not really sure. Don't you know that, too?" Hori was a little surprised. After all, in everyone's impression, Link was an all-knowing intelligence expert. "Unexpectedly, there are things that the other party doesn't know. I can't say I don't know, I just don't know much." Link didn't say anything final, but he didn't want to reveal too much information about Ebrin to avoid arousing suspicion. Hori was a little disappointed when he heard that. Seeing Hori's pitiful look, Link revealed a little information to him. "Although I don't know much, I happened to find some clues on the night the monster appeared. This mysterious monster is likely to have the ability to transform, and can even shrink its body and disguise itself as a human." After saying that, Link picked up the juice next to him and drank it all. "So, the monster is probably hiding among the crowd." Hori frowned and looked at the hotel building not far away. The hotel occupancy rate is as high as 80%, and without specific inspection methods, this is indeed tricky. "So what suggestions do you have? How can we troubleshoot it?" Hori asked anxiously. "Last night, the seaside power plant was attacked. I discovered that before the explosion, all the electricity was absorbed, so I inferred that the monster's target was electricity." Link expressed his speculation. "Electricity." Hori held his chin in his hand and pondered. At this moment, a voice came from the side, "Horui." Then, Sanada Ryosuke slowly walked over with a friendly smile on his face. "I didn't expect to meet you here. It's been a long time since we last met." He appeared to be smiling, but secretly his back was soaked with sweat, and it was obvious that he was very nervous inside. Because just now, he heard the conversation between the two and was worried that his secret would be exposed. That's why he rushed forward to interrupt them regardless of the risk of being exposed. "Ryosuke, it's you." Seeing his former best friend, Hori's face immediately showed excitement. "Horui, I heard you're doing pretty well in the victory team." Sanada Ryosuke hugged Hori. Then his eyes involuntarily drifted towards Link and asked, "Who is this?" "Oh, this is Mr. Link, the intelligence consultant of RTPC. Hori introduced it to his best friend with great enthusiasm. When he heard Link's name, Sanada Ryosuke's heart tightened and his face looked grim. Because he had heard of Link's name. This is the intelligence master that even Director Sawai admires. In their circle, Link's name is well known. "Ryosuke, what's wrong with you? You look so bad, are you feeling unwell?" Hori noticed something unusual and asked with concern. Sanada Ryosuke nodded and said, "I have been feeling a little unwell lately. Sorry, I have to excuse myself now." Hori glanced at Link apologetically and said, "Sir, I will take Ryosuke to rest first. I will have a long talk with you later." After saying that, he helped Ryosuke away in a hurry. Link watched them leave, a hint of amusement on his lips. Looking at the state of Sanada Ryosuke, I guess the Ebron cells haven't completely devoured him yet, but judging by the plot development, it will happen soon. Link thought back to the original plot, compared it to the current timeline, and came to this conclusion. So, the monster Ebron is almost going to make his official debut. In that case, it's time to stretch your muscles. In the quietness of the hotel, Ryosuke Sanada fell into unprecedented panic and confusion. In panic, he turned away Hori and Sayaka. His face was twisted and hideous, and the darkness in his heart seemed to devour him. He rolled around on the ground frantically, his voice trembling. This, what on earth is going on? Is this a new side effect? Clearly, he had absorbed enough electricity and thought he had completed the initial evolution. But at this moment, his body was attacked by an indescribable coldness, and his cells seemed to be cruelly torn apart, and he let out a painful wail. With trembling hands, he hurriedly pulled open the sleeve of his right arm, only to see that it was covered with dense spots and pustules, which were particularly glaring under the light. Suddenly, there was a sharp sound of electricity, and along with it, the lights in the room went out. Instead, a green light lit up on his body, strange and terrifying, as if foreshadowing the unknown fate he was about to face. Dark as ink, the hotel's underground power plant was filled with a strange atmosphere at this time. Just now, the alarm from the management office broke the silence, indicating a large amount of power loss. A security guard was urgently dispatched to check. In the dim corridor, the security guard suddenly saw a green light flashing in the corner. What is that? The security guard looked nervous and shone the light towards the corner. The shadow on the wall quickly enlarged and a terrifying and hideous monster came into view. What? The security guard screamed in fear and turned to run away. The sound of his footsteps echoed in the empty corridor, adding to the eeriness. Soon, the ferocious monster absorbed all the electricity from the power station and let out a satisfied roar. The terrifying roar caused everyone in the hotel, which was already plunged into darkness, to fall into extreme panic. And in the darkness, a mysterious man wearing a brown coat and black framed glasses was hiding in the dark and observing all this. At this moment, Hori, who received the news, rushed over and immediately fired a tracking bullet to try to stop the monster from wreaking havoc. The victory swallow followed closely behind, raining bullets at the monster. But the monster raised its head, blue plasma lightning flashed all over its body, and then it disappeared out of thin air. Nani, disappeared. Everyone on the victory team was horrified. Plasma teleportation. The mysterious man, on the other hand, looked calm, as if he had expected this. Then, while everyone's attention was distracted, he sneaked into the power plant with a briefcase. He came to a secluded place and found a small piece of monster fragment. This is what's left after the victory team attacked the monster. The mysterious man put on protective gloves, carefully placed the fragments into a box, and then quickly left the scene. Before leaving, he glanced in the direction of the victory team, with a meaningful look in his eyes. Dagu, we will see each other again in the future. At the same time, on the top floor of the hotel suite, Link stood in front of the floor-to-ceiling window, staring sharply down. With his supervision, he can easily see everything even if he is thousands of meters away and there are countless obstacles in between. Therefore, not only the actions of the monsters and the victory team, but even the mysterious man with glasses who was taking advantage of the situation could not escape Link's eyes. Kurino Makufu, I remember this guy seemed to have superpowers. Link had a thoughtful look on his face. Recalling the plot of Tiga in my mind, Makuo Kurino seemed to possess two superpowers, telepathy and predicting the future. Didn't this guy appear in episode 39? How come he appeared earlier now? Is it the butterfly effect caused by me? Link looked at the bustling night scene outside the window, and this guess came to his mind. Then, he thought of something and asked, "System, can Kurino Makufu predict something related to me?" Ding. Host. Please rest assured that your future cannot be predicted by anyone for the time being. Once a threat that can predict your future appears, your evolution mechanism will be triggered, and you will evolve targeted superpowers. Hearing this, Link's doubts finally dissipated and a smile reappeared on his face. Things are getting more and more interesting as they develop. The next morning, the sun shone through the gaps in the curtains, bringing warmth to the hotel. Link had just returned from morning exercise at the beach. He walked briskly into the hotel, but found the atmosphere here to be unusually solemn. Sir, You are back. Zongfang hurried forward to greet him. Link nodded in greeting. You guys reacted pretty quickly. The monster tracker has been showing that the target is in the hotel, but we have searched carefully and found nothing. I hope you can help. Zongfang came to Link mainly to ask for his help. Link did not disappoint him and said in a very sure tone, "Of course you didn't find it, because that monster was transformed by Sanada Ryosuke." "What? Is it Ryosuke Sanada who has changed?" Upon hearing this, Zongfang was stunned. A flash of disbelief flashed across Hori's face, and then he fell silent. He turned and rushed to the seventh floor, shouting, "I want to check it myself." Seeing this, Shinjo was worried that something might happen to Hori, so he immediately chased after him. Munakata was still confused, so he asked Link, "Sir, was that monster really Sanada Ryosuke?" Link smiled and explained, "In fact, I have been keeping an eye on that man for a long time. After my secret investigation, I found that he is related to the Space Development Bureau and is involved in the theft of Ebron cells. That's why I am sure that the monster is related to him." Zongfang was deep in thought, and sighed in his heart again, he was indeed the man the captain had chosen. "Deputy Captain, just in case, I suggest evacuating the remaining guests immediately," Dagu said with urgency in his tone. "The hotel is now deserted. Most of the guests checked out in a hurry and fled last night for fear of the monster attacking again. However, there are still some people who did not check out." Zongfang took a deep breath and gave a decisive order. "Daji Yu, you are responsible for leading people to seal off the hotel and immediately carry out emergency evacuation." He turned to Link and said with concern, "I will arrange for someone to escort you away." Link waved his hand, "No need." Munakata had a vague idea of Link's strength, so he didn't force it. Link suddenly asked, "By the way, what were the casualties caused by the monster last night?" Munakata didn't understand what he meant, but out of respect for Link, he answered truthfully, "The monster seemed to intentionally avoid humans when it appeared. Although some people were injured, no one died." Upon hearing this, Link thought to himself, "It seems that it still retains a little conscience and has not been completely swallowed by the darkness." Thinking of this, he already had a plan in mind. "My goal is to be the strongest in the world. No matter in the past or in the future, I will prove to the world that I, Sanada Ryosuke, am the strongest." As soon as the invisible Link stepped onto the stairs to the seventh floor, he heard the resentful roar from Sanada Ryosuke. Boom! Suddenly, there was a loud bang. Ryosuke Sanada broke through the door and turned into a distorted blue electric light, quickly running through the corridor, breaking through the glass, and leaping into the sky. Blue plasma flashed, and Ebron's huge figure appeared. Roar! It was seen crushing countless buildings with one foot, destroying their foundations in an instant, while pulling up electric wires and dancing like a mad snake. The electric current sizzled and rushed into Ebron's body madly, and every cell in it greedily devoured the electrical energy. "Go, we have to get out of here." Shinjo's face changed drastically, and he quickly pulled Sayaka towards safety. Seeing his best friend transformed into a monster, Hori's face was filled with shock and anger. He was unable to stop Ryosuke Sanada and could only watch the situation get out of control. At this moment, Daji Yu appeared. "The opportunity has come." He quickly took out his magic wand and prepared to transform. "Daji Yu, you transformed in the hotel, aren't you afraid of being caught by the hotel surveillance?" Link's teasing voice sounded out of nowhere. Dagu's body shook, and he looked around in shock, "Link." Although he didn't see the person, he recognized it as Link by the voice. "It's me." Seeing the confusion on Dagu's face, Link explained, "I'm invisible. Let me handle this matter. There are surveillance cameras everywhere in the hotel. If you transform now, you will probably be exposed." "Surveillance?" Dagu frowned. He had forgotten about this in his haste. "Okay, then it's up to you. Well, go help evacuate the crowd from the hotel." After instructing Daji Yu, Link flew out of the hotel and transformed into Ultraman after a long time. Just, the sky seemed to be torn apart, and colorful light particles turned into waterfalls and fell from the sky. A black and gold figure stepped out of the waterfall, emitting dazzling colorful light all over. "Ultraman Link, here we go. It's the motherland." Hori was in the elevator, witnessing all this through the glass, his face full of shock. "Horui, please save Ryosuke. The moment Sayaka saw her motherland's Ultraman, she immediately pleaded with Hori. She knows how powerful her motherland is. It was because she knew this that she was worried that Sanada Ryosuke would be killed by the other party. But before she could finish her words, Shinjo grabbed Hori. Shinjo. Hori looked at Shinjo in astonishment. Horui, I know you are friends with them, but Sanada Ryosuke has embarked on another evil path. Shin Cheng said seriously. So, we can't be soft-hearted. As soon as Shinjo finished speaking, the voice of Iruma K came through the communicator. Shinjo is right, Hori, in order to protect the safety of the earth and the people, we can't be soft-hearted. After several previous attempts, Iruma Kea realized that Sanada Ryosuke's psychological distortion had gone to extremes. Being kind to such people is seeking death. I see. Hori took a deep breath. This is the path that Sanada Ryosuke chose to take. Even if he wanted to save her, he was powerless. The other side. The moment Ebrin saw Ultraman Link, he immediately became jealous. He couldn't accept his own ugliness after evolution, and was full of jealousy and anger at Link's handsome figure after his transformation. Why can he be so handsome after transformation, but I am so smart but so ugly after transformation? Ebrin roared, his voice full of resentment and anger. It seems that the other party has gone insane. Hearing such absurd words reminded Link of the whirlwind kick in Shaolin soccer. Link shook his head. Since the opponent was already in deep trouble, he no longer had any concerns and immediately activated his super speed force and rushed towards the opponent. Roar! Ebrin roared, his claws were as fast as lightning, a strong light burst out instantly, and the electric energy beam flooded the space. However, this move was completely useless against Link. After activating the speed force, Link has entered the realm of time dilation. In a moment of near stillness, he easily dodged Ebron's electrical energy beam. He poured energy into his fist, which shone with brilliant light, and swung it fiercely towards Ebrin. Boom! A punch hit Ebrin, and sparks flew instantly, as brilliant as fireworks. It's not over yet. Link didn't give Ebrin any chance to struggle. In just a moment, he threw out hundreds of punches. Bang 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 bang. The terrifying force swept through like a storm, bombarding Ebron's body frantically. When Link exits the time dilation realm, countless electric sparks flashed from Ebron's body. This is clearly a sign of serious injury and energy depletion. Ah, Ebrin howled in agony as his body began to disintegrate. It didn't understand why it was fine 1 second and on the verge of disintegration the next. For this final blow, I will use 2 million calories of energy to destroy the Ebrin cells in your body in one fell swoop. If you're lucky, you might survive. If you're unlucky, then just consider yourself unlucky. Link used telepathy to send a message to Sanada Ryosuke. Then, he mobilized 2 million calories of energy and gathered them into a spiritual light bullet in his palm. The spirit light bullet emitted colorful light, like a gorgeous and bright sun, and instantly hit Ebrin at a speed faster than the speed of light. Do not. Ebrin sensed something was wrong, but it was too late. He could only watch the light bullet hit him and feel a strong energy rushing into his body. Boom. The energy wreaked havoc and destruction, forming a giant ball of light. Ebrin, who was in the ball of light, screamed, and his huge body turned into pieces bit by bit. The other side, Sayaka looked desperate, collapsed to the ground, and burst into tears. She witnessed everything and knew that Sanada Ryosuke was probably beyond redemption. Ryosuke, Hori sighed, stood silently, and mourned for his close friend. The atmosphere in the command room was solemn. Looking at the live broadcast on the screen, a look of relief appeared on Iruma Hui's face. Finally done. My man is still the most reliable. It seems that I have to reward Link handsomely when I go back home at night. Suddenly, Dagu's scream was heard from the communicator. Look everyone, there seems to be someone in the light. Upon hearing this, everyone looked up suddenly and subconsciously looked towards the center of the light ball. Sure enough, there was a person in the light. The man was wearing dark trousers and a light-colored suit, and it was actually Ryosuke Sanada. This, Hori was shocked, then he reacted and shouted, Sayaka, look, Ryosuke is not dead. Sayaka, who was already in despair, was stunned for a moment when she heard this, then looked up. This, Sayaka's eyes widened, her face full of disbelief. Hori helped Sayaka up and said quickly, now is not the time to cry. Ryosuke may still be alive. Let's go over and confirm it. Yes, hurry over. Sayaka also came to her senses, quickly broke free from Hori's hand, and ran quickly towards Sanada Ryosuke. Just now I was limp all over, but now I am full of energy again. Is this the power of love? Shinjo shook his head and hurried to catch up, while at the same time observing a moment of silence for Hori in his heart for 2.5 seconds. Ding. Energy X1 detected, do you want to absorb it? Absorb. Ding. The energy has been absorbed and converted into genetic energy by 70 million calories. The energy limit has exceeded 3,130 million calories. Ding. Due to the influence of this energy, you have evolved superpowers, electric energy beam. Ding. Since the electric energy beam and the elemental power have the same origin, they have been automatically integrated into a superpower, the power of nature. You're lucky. Seeing that Sanada Ryosuke was not dead, Link couldn't help but sigh at his other party's luck. Shaking his head, Link activated his reverse transformation and disappeared into countless colorful light particles. Shortly after Link left, Hori and others arrived at the scene. At this time, Ryosuke Sanada in the ball of light slowly landed on the ground. Hori stepped forward to catch Sanada Ryosuke, put him on the ground, and after a careful examination, he exclaimed in surprise, "There's a pulse. He's still alive." Sayaka was very surprised when she heard this and held Sanada Ryosuke's hand tightly. This scene made Hori, who was standing by, feel a little embarrassed. Shincheng, on the other hand, was quite shocked at this moment. The monsters were all smashed into pieces, but Ryosuke Sanada, the host, was fine. What on earth is it? Ebrin cells and Sanada Ryosuke have merged into one, and should be indistinguishable from each other. But after Ebrin was destroyed, Sanada Ryosuke miraculously survived. Shincheng frowned, he couldn't figure it out. At this moment, Iruma K's order came through the communicator. Horui, Shinjo, you will bring Sanada Ryosuke back to the headquarters later and give him a detailed examination. Yes, Hori and Shinjo nodded upon hearing this. Suddenly, Ryosuke Sanada's eyelashes trembled slightly, he slowly opened his eyes and woke up from his coma. At first glance, he saw Hori's chubby face and Sayaka's tearful eyes, and his heart was full of confusion. He wondered to himself, I should have died, why did I? Hori squatted down gently, patted Sanada Ryosuke's shoulder, and looked at Sayaka again with mixed feelings. In Sanada Ryosuke's heart, he always felt that Hori was superior to him, so he tried his best to prove himself. But in terms of love, Hori always felt that Sanada Ryosuke, who was favored by Sayaka, was always better than him. All I can say is that people's joys and sorrows are not the same. Ryosuke, the motherland has given you a chance to be reborn, I hope you can cherish it. Hori's words were filled with sighs. After hearing what Hori said, Sanada Ryosuke finally remembered what had just happened and felt a sudden fear in his heart. Fortunately, his motherland stopped him, otherwise. Shinjo's attitude was cold. Sanada Ryosuke, you have committed crimes such as stealing cosmic cells, conducting private experiments, destroying power plants, and threatening public safety. Our victory team will formally arrest you. Ah, Ryosuke Sanada just sighed and didn't try to defend himself. Because he also knew that he deserved it. At the same time, without anyone noticing, Makuo Kurino secretly picked up some fragments of Ebron's body and sealed them up. After returning home and placing the body parts, his face was unusually gloomy. Sure enough, I can't peek into the future of my motherland. My superpowers don't work on my motherland. In this era full of unknowns and dangers, superpowers are his greatest asset and the basis for his survival. Once he loses his superpowers, he might be affected and die tragically at the hands of a monster one day. In fact, Makuo Kurino once hated this superpower because it caused him to experience countless tragedies as a child. He hated those whose prophecies came true, and he hated the superpower itself. But now, he can't do without superpowers. What an irony. At present, the only ones who cannot predict the future are the Motherland and the Marvel Clan. A trace of determination flashed in Kurino Makuo's eyes, maybe they are too special, or maybe my superpowers are too weak. As long as I become stronger. Speaking of this, Kurino Makuo thought of someone in his mind. Masaki Keigo, if I have him to help me, I will definitely become stronger quickly. In the afternoon, TPC Far East headquarters, inside the operations command room. Hori held a stack of reports and reported with a complicated expression. "Captain, the results of the examination are out. Aside from being overexerted, there is nothing wrong with Ryosuke's body." Iruma K quickly scanned the report, frowning. "Where are the fragments of Ebron's body, and what about Sanada Ryosuke's test subjects?" "All have been recovered." Hori's expression was serious, but one of the test subjects had an accident. "What accident?" Iruma K asked seriously. Hori replied, "It was a monkey. It died 3 months ago due to an experimental error and was disposed of by the Space Development Bureau." Yi Rui added, "The body of the monkey has been incinerated." Iruma Wei breathed a sigh of relief, but still checked every document carefully to make sure nothing was missed. At the same time, in a dilapidated factory building, in the depths of the darkness, a few weak lights barely illuminate the space, forming a lonely circle of light. There are seats arranged in a circle in the center of the venue. But the strange thing is that there was no one in the seat. Suddenly, dark shadows flashed by like lightning, and the seats were occupied in an instant. The black shadows were more than 2 meters tall. They were dressed in uniform black clothes, looked like crows, and their eyes flashed with strange light. They are actually the Lepixians, who are known for abducting aliens. The red-eyed Lebic in the main seat spoke up, his voice low and majestic, "How is the information you have collected about the Earth?" The subordinates looked similar, but they all had different gleams in their eyes, with a hint of cunning in them. A yellow-eyed Lebic reported in a hoarse voice, "Boss, the Earth is protected by the TPC, the Giant of Light, and the Marvel Clan. With our current strength, I'm afraid it will be difficult to fight against them." The boss nodded slightly and said thoughtfully, "Well, you are right. With our current strength, we are not yet able to confront them head-on. We need to act with caution. Although they are an intelligent race, they possess considerable strength and technology. But they still find it difficult to fight against the three major forces at the same time." At this time, another subordinate spoke up, "Actually, there is a solution. If we disperse our actions, avoid the three major forces, and secretly capture those Earthlings." These words instantly aroused the greed of the Lebics, and their eyes flashed with desire. This planet has a population of billions, and for them, it is a huge slave market. Greed flashed in the boss's eyes. "That's right, disperse the actions and capture humans secretly. This opportunity is rare and cannot be missed." "Yes," the subordinates responded in unison. The night was as heavy as ink. There was no one on the quiet road. Even the broken street lamp stood alone on the roadside, with no one paying attention to it. Link's attention was drawn to a strange sound. He looked in the direction of the sound and saw a crow hiding in the lush green leaves. The pitch-black feathers blended into the night, and only the scarlet eyes flickered in the darkness, staring at Link. Just as their eyes met, the crow suddenly let out a shrill scream, then flapped its wings and fled in a hurry. Link was puzzled. "Huh, I tried my best to restrain the bio-force field, but why did I still disturb these crows?" He shook his head and continued walking until he came to the familiar Chinese restaurant. Since Iruma K had to work overtime again tonight, he had to come here to eat alone. However, after Link entered, he found that the Chinese restaurant was unusually deserted today. Link asked the boss, "Boss, why is business so bad? Did something happen recently?" The boss sighed and answered in a low voice, "Yes, a lot of people have disappeared around here recently. Everyone is too scared to go out. With fewer people, business is naturally down." Missing, Link's heart moved, and he inexplicably thought of the crow just now. Could it be that the story of the Lebics has begun? Just then, Kashiwamura Reiko and Mayumi came in through the curtain. When they saw Link, they greeted him warmly. "Mr. Link, I didn't expect you to eat here too," Mayumi said in surprise. Link said, "I'm a regular here, but you and Dr. Kashiwamura, I didn't expect you to be best friends." Looking at Mayumi holding Kashiwamura Reiko's arm, it is not difficult to see the close relationship between them. Taking the initiative to sit at the same table with Link, Kashiwamura Reiko took the lead in asking, "Link, what do you think about the recent disappearances?" Link groaned and said, "If it goes as expected, it should be done by the aliens." Both women looked surprised after hearing this. Obviously, they didn't expect Link to be so sure. Link said with some mystery, According to the intelligence I have collected recently, this disappearance case is related to the Lebek people. Kashiwamura Reiko's beautiful eyes moved. Lebek. Sure enough, this man was full of mysteries, and she was extremely eager to explore more deeply. Unfortunately, the other party rejected her. But the more Link refuses, the greater her desire to explore Link becomes. It really proves the saying that what you can't get will always make you restless. Soon, the dishes were served, smelling delicious. In particular, the new dish, grilled bull whip, has a brown surface and is dotted with chili powder, which forms a sharp contrast with the green leaves. Let's eat first and chat while we eat. Link picked up a skewer of roasted bull whips and took a light bite. The gravy overflowed in his mouth and the spicy taste of the chili stimulated his taste buds. It's delicious. Mayumi looked on enviously, her eyes full of desire. You're welcome. I ordered a lot. Feel free to eat as much as you want. I, Master Lin, will pay for tonight's meal. Link waved his hand with great generosity. Really? Then I'm not welcome. Mayumi has been in contact with corpses many times and has seen people with strong tastes. She is of course not averse to bullwhips and soon joins the group in tasting them. On the other hand, Reiko Kashiwamura is more of a lady and doesn't dare to try the bullwhip at all. Even if I starved to death, I would never eat something so disgusting. However, when Link forced a bullwhip into her mouth, her attitude immediately changed and she began to eat the roasted bullwhip with relish. Really fragrant. After the meal, the boss thoughtfully served us a plate of hammy melon. As Link was savoring the cantaloupe, the communicator in his pocket suddenly vibrated. He took out his communicator and Megumi Iruma appeared on the screen. At this time, she asked anxiously, Link, we encountered a kind of crow people, do you have any specific information? If you encounter an unknown alien, ask Link for advice immediately. This has become the consensus of Kei Iruma and even the entire victory team. There's nothing I can do about it, Link is a know-it-all. Link nodded, I happen to know something. If this crow man is wearing a suit, then it might be a Lebek. This is consistent with Shinichi's previous description. Those crows are indeed wearing suits. Shincheng suddenly appeared and asked anxiously, Link, what do those Lebeks want to do? What is their intention? When Mayumi heard that her cousin was also involved, her pretty face changed and she wanted to stand up involuntarily. Link noticed her nervousness and said to comfort her, don't worry too much. The Lebek people's goal is to kidnap humans as slaves. As long as these people have not been transported out of the earth, they are temporarily safe. The value of a slave depends on his human qualities. Therefore, the Lebeks will not harm the kidnapped people at will. After hearing this, Mayumi's tense expression relaxed a little. Link asked Shincheng again, by the way, what happened to your cousin now? Shinjo still looked anxious. That Shinichi might want to learn from the victory team, so he wanted to follow the crow man, so I don't know what his current situation is. Link suggested. Then don't just sit there and worry, take action quickly. Iruma K also agreed and told Daigo, Daigo, go with Shinjo to track down the Lebeks. Be careful. Yes, Daigo and Shinjo responded in unison. Immediately afterwards, Iruma K ordered Nori to track down Shinichi's phone number and address. The location is in East Park in the D2 area. Nori responded quickly. After getting the address, Daigo and Shincheng immediately put on their helmets and hurried away. Link also hung up the communicator, and then comforted Mayumi. Don't worry, your cousin is so smart, he should be fine, and I promise you that I will bring him back safely. With Link's comfort, Mayumi felt a little better. Boss, I have to leave first because I have something urgent to do. I'll settle the bill another day. The boss waved his hand and said, go ahead and do your work. There's no rush to settle the bill. Link thanked them, said hello to the two women, and then turned and left. Looking at Link's departing back, Mayumi's face was still full of worry. And Kashiwamura Reiko comforted her, don't worry, Link is very reliable and always keeps his word. Since he has promised so much, I believe he can definitely save Shinichi. Okay, Mayumi nodded, put her hands in front of her chest in a praying gesture, and prayed silently in her heart. At the same time, in the early morning in East Park, the fog has not yet completely dissipated. Shinichi hid behind a low bush, carefully observing the Lebek people in front of him. The creature had sharp yellow eyes and was holding a shrinking ray gun. It was searching around and making low roars from time to time. Shinichi's eyes were determined. I must uncover the secret of this crow man. He stayed close to the ground, slowly following behind the Levick. However, when the Levick disappeared around the corner, Shinichi suddenly froze. He tilted his head in confusion, but could not find any trace of the other person. At this moment, the sound of footsteps suddenly came. Shinichi's heartbeat quickened and he turned around suddenly, only to see a familiar figure approaching. I hope everyone will support it and subscribe more.